You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
Hello. What's up, everybody? We are back with YKWD Live. We have a great show today. We have a bunch of people that we know, and then we have a brand new dude. Let's get into this. And we have, for the first time ever, guests in the studio. We said to you, right, Deepu? I mean, Scopo? Fuck, I hate your names.
It's Chrissy.
Oh, Chrissy.
Yeah, we said, let's get some guests in here now on, from now on.
We have and we have, you guys are the first guests in the new studio. Welcome. What's your names, and where are you from?
I'm Chris from Connecticut.
Your name is Fish?
Chris. Sorry. Bobby Chris.
I would have liked Fish.
I'm Eddie from Brooklyn.
Wow, you guys are interesting. I really fucking spice up the show.
What the fuck?
Did you know you were coming on? Did you maybe plan something?
Yeah, you know, I answered the question.
Well, where you from, dude? I guess this radio thing isn't as fucking easy as it seems.
Everybody has a podcast.
Hope you guys don't. We have a two-minute podcast. It's called fucking Chris, and what's your name again?
Eddie.
You didn't tell me that we're supposed to do the podcast for you. You
said, oh, you're not. Trust me. You just fucking ruined that idea that we had. But no, it's cool. Dude, don't worry about it.
Thanks for letting us come in and watch.
No, guys. Thanks for coming on. And where are you from, Chris?
I'm from Watertown, Connecticut. Near Litchfield, Connecticut, where all the rich people live.
Are you rich?
No.
Okay. That would explain the Ghostbusters hoodie.
Yeah, it's, you know, the finest one.
And where are you from, bro?
I'm from Bushwick, Brooklyn.
Bushwick, Brooklyn. And do you know each other at all?
No.
So you guys are just fucking friends from this. Now you'll know each other from this.
Yeah. Pure coincidence, yeah.
All right. Who would you fuck in the room? Besides her. No, I'm kidding. Don't answer that question.
Gotta go gay.
Yeah. We go gay right away.
Yeah, you gotta go gay.
That's the way we get it out of the way. You know what I mean? Well, thanks for coming in. If you guys want to be on the show, how do they do it, Chris?
They can email ykwdproducer@riotcast.com. And subject coming on the show or want to come on the show.
Right. All right, cool. And, yeah, we're going to start having a lot of guests in here. I want to let you know we're trying to get a live show going in the next couple weeks with a with surprise guests.
Don't mention the guest.
I'm not mentioning them all.
That person said don't mention it because there's a problem with something.
Okay, yeah. Really?
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, now I got to go see this live show.
Yeah.
Ooh, there's problems.
Mm-hmm.
So much speculation.
I know what you're talking. I know what the problem could be.
What is it? Yes.
Right, but if it's not, we still have the other one.
Oh, yeah,
which would still be a great guest.
Fantastic guest.
So,
it's
we still have, one guest. No, I'm kidding. So, anyways, it's going to be at the Village Underground at the lounge upstairs. I'm going to start doing live shows up there. And, what else do we have? What else, Chris? What else do I have to announce? I remember we said,
if fans also want to send in items from the back behind you.
If you look behind me, all this stuff is sent by fans. So if you guys want to send shit to us, some gotsy shit to put on the bookshelf behind me, where do they send it to?
Just tell me you're sending it first at ykwdproducer@riotcast.com. Then send it to the Comedy Cellar, 117 McDougal Street, and put care of Robert Kelly.
What's the zip code?
I didn't go that far ahead. All right.
You didn't get the ad.
I got 117 McDougal Street. Just put it in there, and if it comes, it comes. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know. We'll figure it out.
The fucking dumbest guy on the fucking planet.
Oh, nope, that's not it.
Forget it. Come back to it.
10012.
Nice. That was pretty quick. Great work,
Bobby. I sent you the Bill Murray picture behind you.
Where?
Up on the shelf near in between the Jameson bottles.
I fucking love you. Can we straighten that out a little bit? There you go. Yeah. Fucking great, dude. I love that. It's one of our most. Did you like it when you saw it on the show?
Yeah.
Did you go, hey, honey, look. Yeah, I told you they'd fucking you.
They'll never fucking put
it. You're like, they fucking you, fucking twat. They used it. Every show I'm in it. Do you have a girlfriend?
No.
Oh, boy. Mm. That fucking bit didn't really make sense. It just made you sad. All right. Well, let's go around the room. Of course, we have my pal.
Hello.
Well, you know what, Chris, you do this. This is your thing. Well, we should have Lauren do this.
No.
All right, Chris, you do it.
All right, so my right, we have a very funny comedian, Zac Amico, everybody. First time on the YKWD podcast.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Zach from Brooklyn. Hey, Bobby. Hey, everybody. Thanks for having me on, man.
Dude, I'm excited to have you on. I heard about you a while ago. Lewis came in here and fucking started a ruckus with you two.
Oh, my pro wrestling manager, Lewis Jacobus.
He does take all the credit for you.
Does he really?
Oh, yeah. He is so my Bobby the Brain here.
Every time he has a good joke, he goes, you know, that joke is because of me. I got you on the show. It's because of me.
Yeah, I wonder where you learned that from.
I wish I could do that with Chris. Wow. Okay.
Boo.
Yeah, well, where's the bandana? That was you can't
pretty boo. Good. That was good.
You can't boo that motherfucker.
Oh, I booed okay? it.
No,
I
you
booed
can't.
It.
Let me see that.
I chuckled.
All right, I'll take it. I don't give a shit. And then who do we go next to him?
From the Sam Roberts Show. Sam Roberts, everybody.
There's no the. It's just Sam Roberts Show, and there's an apostrophe after the last S because it's possessive.
Sorry, sir.
No. That's okay. I mean, I thought everybody knew that.
I thought it was because it's cunty. What the fuck, Sam?
Jesus, really?
It's branding.
It's important. Branding?
Yeah.
How long have you been branding?
What? Wow.
Since they gave him a shittier time slot.
What'd you say, Zach?
Since they gave him a shittier time slot.
Hey, you can take it. I actually
saved yourself.
I made him repeat it.
I forced you to get that. I'm a fucking dildo. All right, I'm trying to do. Let's go. Who's next?
And then last we have Stavros Halkias.
Hello, everybody.
Nice. Newly to New York, Stavros.
That's right.
Also, we have Deepu.
Yo.
Lauren.
Hey.
And we have Adrian in the room.
He's here for me.
Hey, Adrian. Sam's boy. Sam's guy.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if I like this because you were, Adrian, first of all, you were with.
Adrian, step up to the microphone.
First of all, you were my guy first.
No, he wasn't.
Well, no, I wasn't.
Adrian, I will get the fucking footage. I will get the audio. You came here. You weren't Sam's guy. You were Opie and Anthony's guy. Not fucking Sam's.
But okay? I did report to Sam.
No, you didn't report to nobody. You fucking were my...
technically I reported to E-Rock, but then I just started
technically
reporting
to Sam. You fucking reported to me, okay? E-Rock, I'll take E-Rock, I'll take anybody else, but not fucking Sam. You were my guy before Sam's guy. You came here, I fucking took you under my wing, and I fucking embraced you, and I taught you the ropes on how to open the door, how to get a coffee.
Cream and sugar.
Cream and sugar.
Yeah. No sugar. You should know this. Adrian, come
God
on.
God damn
no
it.
No grains, no
I'm
sugar.
God.
I mean, I'm Sam's
thank
guy
you,
now.
Thank you, sweetie. Gotcha.
I don't even drink coffee.
And then,
I don't even drink coffee. He doesn't need to know anymore.
I don't need to do that.
Oh, motherfucker.
He's been retrained. Do you understand?
Dude, retrained.
I'm on top of my shit.
No, you're not on top of nothing. Look, I see you sweating. You're nervous.
He's not. He's nervous.
It's hot in here.
He's nervous because he's next to me, the boss,
the big guy.
We'll see how long this lasts. This show, free, goes on forever. That show, they pay a lot of money. That could get canceled anytime. Then where are you going to be?
Yeah. I mean, I'll just go wherever Sam goes.
Oh, really? You're going to go to fucking Scarsdale to his apartment? Do the Sambo show out of a fucking closet? Is that where you're going? Look around, my friend. We're doing big things.
Yeah, it looks nice in here. I mean, AC would be great.
We have AC over here. I can't help it if you're a fucking sweaty, pale white guy. All right. Well, you know what? Fuck you, dude. Okay.
I mean, I'm happy to be back, but I'm like.
Well, why don't you show it by fucking.
I'm here with Sam.
Look at you. I'll split custody with him. Okay.
I got 100% to be the split. 100%.
First of all, I didn't allow him in the studio.
He's here with me.
Yeah. No, but you. We don't allow. We don't.
I didn't text him. I was going to text him to come in, but I forgot to do it.
Wait, I brought him.
He just comes.
Yeah, but here's the deal. We don't allow producers and publicists in the studio.
That is very true.
That's true. So but yes. He's technically, he's unless my... unless you're a
But I'm not really either of those things. I'm just his guy.
It's different.
You know? It's kind of like whatever he needs.
You're getting away on a technicality today, but I'm going to look into this. And next time, you need
a guy clause.
Guy clause.
I do have a guy clause.
Are you all right, Bobby? It seems like you're a little irritable. with this
It hurts my feelings. On? Because I gave this kid his shot in the biz.
You did. You and Sam, you were the first person.
Shut up, Sam. Let him talk.
You were the first person in the business to show me genuine kindness.
Yes.
It was super nice.
Yep. Keep going.
Help me out with stuff.
Yeah, but he showed you kindness. Guess what? It ain't show friends. It's show business, okay? We don't need kindness.
Yeah.
Okay?
Plus, I kind of, you know, I went for the money.
Yeah, well, listen, dude, you can have a guitar.
I mean, I'll take one today.
No, not if you're fucking part of the show. All right, well, I'm glad that the Sam Roberts show.
It's no the.
Which
it's possessive.
Yeah, Sam Roberts show.
Thank you.
When I'm on it, the Bob and Sam show.
Wow, that's a.
It's a fucking hit. Just get over it, dude. Your numbers skyrocket when I'm on.
That's true. I mean,
fucking rocket to the moon.
You know, people are excited.
Dude, it's like
I don't know.
Fucking like somebody just having a heart attack. It just jolts up, like you know, in Pulp Fiction when they stuck that thing in her
chest. Adrenaline needle.
Yeah, that's what I am to your fucking show. That's why it's Bob and Sam.
Dramatic.
It's unbelievable.
I don't know if it's quite that high, but.
Hey! Oh my God, Estee! Oh my God, Liz, and Estee. Is Estee, can you, Adrian, please get up. No, get the fuck up. Just move. You should have actually instinctually got up. All right, let me tell you something. This is, put the headphones on so you can hear us. Right there. This is a great honor. We've been doing this show for how long? Years.
Up here, like 3 years?
3 years.
I invited her up before, though. I said you come up.
That's the only thing you took, an invite.
And really?
That's all. You've never invited me.
I didn't know it was that. I didn't want to, like, hey, can you want to come up? Because I thought I'd insult you. I have to work. I didn't want you to. But let me just say who this is, everybody. The Comedy Cellar, the great Comedy Cellar, the world famous Comedy Cellar, the best comedy club in the world.
The one and only.
The one and only. The reason why it's one and only. The reason why. It's the best club is because of why? Because the comics that work there. Who picks those people? Who individually picks those and makes the judgment who works this club? Where, when, and how? Estee. That's who.
Thank you.
She's here right now.
Thank you.
And everybody knows about you, and they don't even know you. And they've never even heard you, but everybody who listens to the show knows who you are.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm great.
And they had a great night. I was going to talk about this.
Oh, my God.
I was going to talk about it.
It was really something.
Can you fix her mic so she's on it?
It was really, really something special.
Can you tell people what it was? Because it's hard to explain. It was a Rick Chrome thing, but it turned into something else, right?
Right. It the making a documentary.
Yep.
About Rick Chrome, all his jobs, and history of from Chicago to being a stand-up to being a Broadway guy to. Teaching now comedy, and the way he approaches everything, you know, it's quite special. And as they were doing it, they were interviewing different people throughout the years that worked with Rick.
Right.
And so all these guys.
Estee, you got to turn your show. That's really unprofessional. That's why I don't have you on the show, Estee. Because, oh my
the
God!
Landlord walked in.
The owner of all! Sam, the owner of all, has
this
come in the
incredible.
Room.
This is incredible. What a great show.
Scopo, get the fuck up. No, get over here. This is the best show ever.
Yeah.
No, just sit over here. Sit over here where Scopo's sitting. They have to sit there because I kicked them out. It'd be weird now.
Wow.
This is the owner of all is sitting down. Of course, he's disconnected on the phone.
I'm texting with John Legend. Just hold on.
Are you really? Oh, you really? No. Yeah, well, okay. Just say I'm hanging out with Chris Scopo and Stavros. So she was explaining the other night. So go ahead. I'm sorry for the interruption.
So they interviewed people that throughout the years worked at the Comedy Cellar with him.
Right.
And everybody was so forthcoming and so loving.
Yeah.
And Bill Grumfuss, who was the original MC.
Right. Was he? How did that start? How did the Comedy Cellar? What was the Comedy Cellar before that?
Piano bar.
So Bill comes in.
Right.
And he says, I want to do a comedy show here.
Right. He spoke to Manny. And they, you know, so Manny was willing to try. And he had somewhat experience from college,
mm-hmm.
and he had connection, you know, Paul Reiser and what have you, people that he went to school with,
right.
and work with,
right.
and that's how it started. Charles Zucker was his sidekick; he was playing the piano.
Right.
When Charles Zucker left to L.A., Rick Rohn came in
right.
as his sidekick, and the relationship that developed since then.
Yeah.
So. While they were interviewing everybody, he says, I think it was Noam, it was Bill's idea, right? To do the reunion.
No, it was Dustin's idea.
It was Dustin's? Yeah. Okay. So that.
Or maybe Rick's.
Yeah. The idea somehow came up.
Right.
Let's do a reunion show from 25 years ago.
Right.
And so we decided, one show, it's going to be a reunion show.
Right.
We'll see what happens.
Yeah.
And in the meantime, so Ray Romano is now filming here in the city.
Vinyl, his new show Vinyl.
Yes.
Which is sex,
HBO.
Drugs, and rock and roll, except...
Scorsese and Scorsese. HBO.
Thank you, Essie, for saying what
and
I...
And HBO.
Yeah, it's HBO and Scorsese.
I just want to make it easy on you. And he, Ray being Ray, yeah. a wonderful Ray.
Greatest guy ever.
Right. Agreed to appear.
Yeah.
And then we reached out to Jon Stewart and then somehow Louis. We have Mark Cohen, who was at that time also an MC.
Right.
And a little bit of a conflict with Rick, but then they became great friends.
With who?
With Rick.
Rick Rohn and
Mark Cohen
had a conflict?
Yeah. Because, Rick really didn't know Mark Cohen and gay jokes or what have you, and he thought he's a hater. But it wasn't.
Mark Cohen's gay?
Yes. Oh. No. So, anyway, they became great friends.
Right.
And then Mark Cohen and Alan Havey and Bill flew in from L.A., for that show.
It's crazy.
And then Jon Stewart showed up.
Oh my God.
Ray Romano, Louis C.K.,
right.
Colin.
Colin was down.
And Greer came in. Was fantastic. And those are all guys from 25 years ago.
That's crazy. I walked in. I was around the corner at the Village Underground where they were doing the premiere party for Benders, the new IFC show, which was a fucking blast. It was me, Chris DeStefano,
Andrew Schultz,
Godfrey, Kurt Metzger, and Jim Norton. And they were showing little clips. It was the best premiere I've been to, because usually they show the actual show, which isn't meant to be watched with a group of people, television shows. It can be kind of boring and like nerve-wracking. They just showed our clips and then let us do stand-up. And then there was a massive party upstairs. Then I come over here. And sometimes when you go by the cellar, you know there's like something going on. There's like a weird buzz. There's a weird vibe. There was something happening. I went downstairs, and the hallway's packed. Colin Quinn, then Ray Romano, and Louis C.K., Bill, and Mark Cohen, and then Bill went on with Rick, and they were singing on the piano, and everybody was just fucking dying laughing. You see these greats just sitting there waiting to go on. And it was almost a weird snapshot of back in time what it must have been like, because that's what we do on the weekends with me, Keith. We're all sitting in the hallway waiting to go on, watching the next guy going up, blah, blah. They were doing the same thing. It was just a fucking weird. And there was so much money in that hallway. I was just sitting there going like, Jesus Christ. If everyone could just give me $1 million, I'm fucking done. I'm out. I'll come back. I'll host every weekend. I'll just fucking, I'm done.
The thought of that.
There was a lot of money in this fucking building.
$1 billion.
So
there
funny.
Was a lot of
probably $1 billion.
A fucking ton of cash in that hallway, man.
I thought about everything except of how much money is represented there.
I'm telling you, I looked around, I saw yachts, I saw houses. I mean, I just went Ray and Louis alone, and then Stuart was here. That's fucking crazy.
He was so sweet.
Oh, thank God nothing happened. That would just be we'd lose
like a what?
Anything happened.
That's why we kept it secret.
Did you really keep it a secret?
No. Oh. No. No.
I went downstairs and was literally in awe. First of all, this is what really got me. Bill and Chrome on stage together. I fucking hate the piano. You know this because I'm chubby. And for me to get on stage, I have to maneuver like a fat ballerina. I have to twist and turn at the right moment. God forbid there's a fat host. We have to kind of swivel at the right time or we're knocking somebody's beer or nachos off a table. But the other night, I kind of got the piano and why it's there. Yeah. Rick Chrome and Bill, they did a song to you, a tribute to you.
I know.
That
the
was
girl from Ipanema.
It was so fucking funny. And there was such a, it was like old school comedy that I, you know, I started hating on all this weird shit everybody's doing. You know, like everybody's trying to do different shows and the roast this and the that and the fucking blah. And I was like, can't we just do comedy? Why are we searching for some other fucking way? And I was, the other, I was like, you know what? I kind of got it. I was like, this is just fun. Stand-up comedy is what we do. But that the other night, just seeing them on stage, singing songs, bringing people up. And people were doing old bits. Alan Havey did his
soap on
a rope bit.
Yeah.
So it was just fun to see us having fun again.
And you the know, audience loved it. Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was really hard.
It was one of the funniest shows ever.
It was really hard to be a comic in the hallway hearing that audience. There was something about that. Their laughter was beyond...
organic.
It was a they were fucking having a... like a lot of people were belly laughing, ridiculously having a good time. And it was hard for a comic. Like, I'm sitting there going, fuck. It's almost like, let me get in this.
Did you get to see Mark Cohen?
I didn't. I came in right after.
He killed. He destroyed without one joke.
Yeah. What, he just went up an improv.
Just, yeah.
Really?
Just being Mark Cohen.
Yeah, him and Rick Chrome are fucking fantastic together. But it was great to see Grunf Bill because he's the guy who started it all.
Right.
And where is he?
L.A.
What is he doing?
He's busy in the business.
Is he a writer? Is he?
Yeah, producer, writer.
Right,
you know.
Right. Yeah, you could tell he had a jacket like he was doing something important. You know what I mean? It wasn't a comic jacket. It was, I have a little money. I'm doing some important shit jacket. You were, I didn't even see you. Where were you?
I was there.
Where?
In the room.
In the room on the floaters.
Oh, you were just in the room enjoying it.
Yeah, for the most of the time, yeah.
What'd you think?
It was fantastic.
Well, you've been dying that this was happening at the club.
Yeah.
Wow, okay, good. Why don't I ask these fucking fans?
No, wait, how do you feel? Because
Estee can fucking, she's fucking went through the story, brought us there, up and it was amazing.
Listen, Estee's giving you a good story now, but the truth is, she was very negative about this show all along. Tell them the truth. Tell them. That's why I was silent there, because Estee was...
I'm not talking about planning the show.
I know.
I was telling them how the show was.
So all I was thinking...
No, hang on 1 second.
What?
Boom. So all I have sound effects now.
So all I... That's hack. So all I was thinking... So all I was thinking that the whole time I was sitting there is like, Jesus Christ, you know, that we never mind. there's a lot of pushback sometimes.
No. One night of
Rick Chrome enjoyment, and this is what you come to, right? Sound effects.
What no one is talking about.
Reassessing your whole 20-year career.
What Noam is talking about is exactly what you mentioned before, which I am against as well.
Right.
It's a shtick, you know, a team, whatever. This never can work out. Many times, it doesn't work out well.
Right. Yeah.
What happened, it worked out beyond anything that we planned or we thought it's going to happen, how it's going to, we weren't sure. Yeah. I was sure Ray is going to come.
Yeah.
But I wasn't sure about Jon Stewart. I didn't know about Louis. You know what I mean? So it could. We didn't book it as a reunion show, a regular show.
Right.
That's what it was booked.
This is the thing that nobody around me seemed to understand, Robert.
That you're a genius.
Well, you know, that's one way to put it. No, that. No, and it actually it applies to you too, and this.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to say yes.
Can you get your phone off the table for the love of God? You stop ruining my show.
Oh, John Legend again. I'm sorry.
Are you sure you're saying it right? It's not John Logan. Is he a bass player from Brooklyn?
you have to say yes to things and try things. And then
you're talking about. Are you
What?
Forget it.
No, I'm saying a guy in my position, like, you know, you want to do your podcast.
Is this a pep talk you gave Norton a long time ago?
No.
You have to try things.
But this is the thing. So somebody comes to you with an idea.
Yeah.
And, you know, you don't know what the odds are. Maybe it's 70-30 that it won't come off.
Right.
But you got to try because if you do 100 of them, a certain number of them will work out. But then if they do flop, everybody around you is happy. You know, like they say, I told him not to do it, you know?
Right.
And so that's always the situation. I mean, including doing your pod. You know the pushback I got back letting you do your podcast up here?
Yeah.
From everybody?
No, I didn't, but now it fucked me up. Have you ever decided to say, did your father, you don't have to say everything in your head? Has that ever happened to you?
He always said everything in his head.
Yeah, but he said it in a better way. Listen, the fuck, man?
I'm trying to make your show interesting, you know, and so
well,
I'm trying to be honest.
There's a door right there. If you'd like to make, because it was fucking interesting as shit until your phone ruined it. And John Legend and your shitty things you said to me and Estee. What the hell's interesting about it? Well, this isn't CNN, asshole.
You know, here I am talking about what a good outcome it was that your podcast is so good.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Doing it up here.
Okay.
And you're cutting me down.
I'm sorry. No, I'm kidding with you. I understand what you're saying. That you, look it.
I got a lot of pushback when I was opening the Underground from a lot of comics.
Okay, but I know what Estee's saying.
And then the band, you were freaking out about the band in the Underground opening the, you know, playing the bumper music between the comics.
Yeah.
And now people like, you know, it's like it's always like resistance to everything. And you just have to try things.
But I understand what Estee's saying, and I believe that too. I don't want to walk in. God forbid I walk into the cellar one night, and there's an improv group on stage on a Saturday night. Is there?
No.
Oh, I was going to throw up.
But we used to have.
Okay, used to.
It was an act.
And I don't.
It was a spot.
But I love improv. I'm not saying that. I love
you
that.
You know who it was?
Who?
Please. Michael King.
Who's that?
King and Mindy. He's only the producer of Sex and the City. And
I don't know.
He's huge.
Is he?
Huge.
Like huge, like me huge physically?
No,
or?
Huge like in
no,
the
mentally.
Business.
Mentally?
in the
yeah,
business.
Yeah, but I get it. But like, you know, look, I understand that these theme shows and all this stuff, I get it. And I went to the you know, one of these roast things and it was fun. I had a blast and I think they're cool. But, I feel like there's a lot of times, you know, we got to, you know, bring people on stage and blah, blah, blah. Sometimes I'm like, all right, just can you do, it's hard enough to write a fucking joke and write good stuff and go up there and perform it well. And, you know, and then all of a sudden there's all this other hijinks. But the other night kind of made me go with the piano and the singing
great.
The songs. I was like that. This is fun. I get it. Stand-up's awesome. I love it. But this other stuff is fun. It's kind of, you know, stop being such a comedy snob and check it out.
But also,
Stavros,
are,
don't ever talk when these two are in the room, okay? No, go ahead.
I'm just going to hit the bathroom. but also, those are like the most legendary, some of the most legendary performers ever. So, I mean, you can make an exception when it's that kind of talent and that kind of, those kind of people.
Dude, I was in awe when I walked downstairs. I opened the door. And I was like, what?
Yeah, you should see his face. You were like,
I didn't even know what to say. I mean, I know Louis. Louis saw me. He was like, hey, dude, why didn't you say hi? But I was just looking at Ray Romano's back. It was Jon Stewart, just had left. Louis was there. Bill was there. Rick was there. They were coming off stage. Bill and Chrome came off stage like they were fucking 27. I mean, they were like, we never did that before. They were like,
they were very
they
excited.
They were giddy. They were giddy.
And Louis was, I saw Louis laughing.
He was laughing at Alan. I noticed it too. Yeah. Alan just went to all his
games. Alan Havey fucking murdered.
Yeah.
Murdered.
And I turned around and Louis was just bending over with laughter.
And
he was really laughing.
Alan had some fucking great new shit. I mean, really fun. I mean, everybody was laughing in the heart. It was fun. It was crazy, man. I love seeing that shit. It was crazy.
It was a nice insight into how the comedy community works, where the biggest stars in the world are unequal with people who were not stars at all and will come down and support each other and can still consider themselves all part of the same, all on the same level in a sense.
Yeah.
And that doesn't exist, doesn't seem to exist in the music world anymore. Maybe it did in the 60s, where people would drop in and jam with each other and be supportive of each other. The comedians are quite supportive of each other. And so you see somebody like Jon Stewart showing up, who's, you know, the top 10 biggest stars in the country, right?
Right.
Showing up for Rick Chrome's show. It's pretty unusual.
It's pretty epic. And we do, comics, we do have a huge... community that we do support each other. Even though we talk shit and we're the worst at fucking trashing each other and fucking, you know, saying shit, especially behind each other's backs, but in front of each other's faces, it was really cool to see that epic show happen. And you know, I was just so glad to be a part of it. Yeah, it was amazing. It was amazing.
Yeah,
and you came out and they gave you such a great.
No, that was nice.
They gave you a really great
endorsement.
And well,
no, Bill gave a whole tribute to Estee being the heartbeat of the Comedy Cellar. Yeah. And what else did he say, Estee?
I was the girl from Meep.
The girl with the biggest tits.
All right, relax.
The girl with the biggest tits.
I love how all the comics in the room just quiet down when you two show up. It really is. You don't understand the horrid shit we were saying before you guys showed up. He was ready. He was saying some shit. And now you guys show up. Fucking everybody's on the bed. I mean, are you holding your breath, Zach?
I'm terrified.
I've been meditating.
I was intimidated by Patrice's hat.
And now they're all just clammed up. Do you have anything to say? Do you have any questions you want to ask?
I was banned from speaking earlier. I don't know if you remember.
That was a joke.
Okay.
Good. What do you want to ask? Anything. Anything. These are the people that run the Comedy Cellar right here. I mean, one of them, you know, actually has power. The other one, just on paper, has the money. Go ahead. He has a pool, too.
What do I want to ask?
Yeah. Do you have anything?
Thank you for putting me on the spot there, Bob. I don't.
Let me answer you for it. You got to get two people to recommend you.
Is that how you get into the cellar?
I used to have. Well, even now, if I hear about somebody, I'll ask people that are our comics,
right?
If they know what they think. Right. Used to be recommendation of two other comics and then a DVD, but now with the YouTube clips and whatever, I can pretty much take a look myself.
Right, secretly.
And then invite them for an audition if I like
and
it.
Explain the audition process. What is it?
5-7 minutes live on stage.
On what night?
Friday, last show.
Friday, last show.
Yeah.
What spot?
It's around the second spot.
Second spot. Yeah. Host goes up, comic, and then you.
Exactly.
And you get 5 to 7 minutes.
It depends how they do.
My question is, what's the reasoning behind that, the Friday second show?
Last show.
The last show, I mean.
I don't want to bump comics that are booked for audition.
I see.
Right. And then how do they know if they got it? How do they know?
I talk to them. Afterwards, I talk to them.
Because the last show can run a little bit late if necessary. Because
yeah.
There's no show afterwards, that's why.
Got it.
And how do they know? You talk to them after?
Yes.
And you say yes or you need to come back?
It depends, yeah. I learned not to say 100%, very rarely it's 100% yes.
Right.
Okay, I'll give you some spots. Let's see how it...
Michael Che.
Right away. Right away.
Pete Corielli.
Well, Pete Corielli, it's an old-timer, yeah. Yes.
Robert Kelly.
No, some people, you know, but the newer people, I'm not sure.
Go the other way with that.
Some people I'm not sure whether they're going to work out or not.
Right.
So I'll figure, okay, I'll give them a spot, let's see what happens.
Right.
And if they do well, get another spot and work them in.
Right,
if
right.
it doesn't,
right.
I drop it.
That's great. All right.
We're is gone. The stage name Deepu a showstopper? Is that like a you would never work with a guy like that?
That's oh god, yeah. You know what? You'll, yeah, oh that god. Question is the
yeah.
No, you know what? I want you to leave.
All right.
No, I'm kidding. That's Deepu. Well, this is Stavros. This is
hi, hello.
Hi.
Deepu was a stage name?
That's his name.
Well, it's a family nickname.
Oh.
Yeah.
Is that a family nickname?
Yeah.
What's your real name?
Amardeep. No, we've been over this.
Oh, what the fuck? I'm learning your name is Amardeep a fucking year in? You motherfucker!
We knew this.
We knew this.
There's an episode titled My Actual Name.
We named the show his name one time.
Why is it not like a. It should be on the wall. We should have named Amardeep Studios. Amardeep what?
Last name is Gill. Really lucked out with the last name.
Amardeep Gill.
Amardeep. A-M-A-R.
Amardeep.
No, Amr.
Amardeep.
Yep.
Amardeep.
Yep.
Amardeep.
So, yeah. Really hard. Doesn't work on the
I want shirts mics. Made immediately. Amardeep.
Amardeep.
With a question mark. all right. Well, guys, thank you for coming in. We're going to take
pleasure.
A break real quick. Gnome, the owner of everything. right?
Yeah.
Estee, I love you to death. You're the best.
See you later.
Thank you for stopping by. Liz, thank you for bringing Estee by.
Did you get Liz on the show?
No.
No, Liz,
you need Liz on your show one day.
Liz doesn't come on the show. She hates it.
I do.
Not the show. You don't hate the show.
I hate you. I love you. I don't want to be on the show.
Say you love me into the microphone, please, because they heard that hate loud. Say I love you.
I love you, Robert Kelly.
I love you, too. Estee, I love you.
I love you back, Robert Kelly.
I love you.
I love you a lot, Robert Kelly.
I love you, Estee. Estee, no, do you love me?
Of course I love you, Robert.
Say it better.
Yeah.
Look at me in the
like
eye.
Say like you mean it.
Yeah, don't look at the ceiling. Look at me. Look at me in the eye. Look me right in the eye.
I love you, Robert Kelly.
Wow.
Oh, there's real energy there.
I have. All right, man.
I gotta go. Everybody, all right. Bye.
I'll see you later. Bye, Estee. All right. Listen, man. That was. We're going to take a break real quick. I got to do two reads today, and then we're going to come back into this live show. We got around an hour or so left of it, maybe an hour and 20, but I got to get these reads in, and so just stay tuned. You guys watching live, we'll be right back. You guys listening Monday, it's going to take 2 seconds, all right? You know what, dude?
Yeah, all right, there we go.
That's right, sex, drugs, rock and roll, picked up for season 2. I want to thank all you son of a bitches for watching and spreading the word about the show, because we have picked up for season 2. Starting in February, we'll be filming, and it'll be out the same time. I'm very excited about that. But before that, you son of a bitches, this amazing company. Hang on 1 second there, everybody. This awesome company right now. Yeah, check it out, man. The sun on your face. Your season-long fantasy football team may be going strong, but check this out. You don't have to wait until week 16 to get paid. Put your fantasy skills to the test every week this season at DraftKings.com. America's favorite one-week fantasy football site. All right? With one-week fantasy football, you know what that means? No season-long commitments. All right, you got an injured player, no problem. It's like a new season every goddamn week. So, you're never stuck with the same players. And get this, DraftKings.com is crowning a new millionaire every week this season. That means you could turn your love of football into a payday of a lifetime. Just pick your players, pile up the points, and pick up your cash. That's it. Believe me, you never experienced football like this before. This isn't fantasy as usual. This is DraftKings. Welcome to the big time, boys. Hurry up to DraftKings.com now. Use promo code Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y, and play for free. That's free with your first deposit in this Sunday's $1 million fantasy football contest where, okay, the winner takes home $100,000. Enter Kelly for free entry now. Only at DraftKings.com. That's DraftKings.com. Woo! Check it. All right, here it is. Let me ask you a question. Are you getting enough? Okay. I bet you'd love more, right? Stavros?
Yes.
Zach?
Oh, baby, yeah.
Do you want more?
Mm-hmm.
Well, AdamandEve.com wants to give you more. Check this out. With 10 free gifts. First, you get all this sexy surprise for her. Second, a specially selected toy for him. And third, a little something we know you'll enjoy. Plus, you'll get 6 full-length adult movies on DVD. It's great. I love it. I love it. You know why I love a DVD? Everybody says you go on the internet and get porn. A DVD has the full scene. So you find something you like, and you can stick to it. I like watching from beginning. I like the build-up in a porn scene. Okay? It's unbelievable. And number 10, free shipping. Okay, so you don't have to pay for shipping, which always sucks when you get something. They always tack on another $5 or $10. Free shipping on your entire order. So what do you have to do to get your 10 free gifts? It's not hard. You like that one? Why don't you tell them what they have to get? Why don't you read that? Lauren?
It's not hard.
Oh, God. Yes, it is.
It is now.
Where are you on this? Just enter offer code DUDE at checkout, and you'll get all 10 free gifts. Go check out adamandeve.com today. Select one item and get 10 free gifts, including free shipping, when you enter the offer code DUDE. That's D-U-D-E at adamandeve.com.
Would you get something?
Oh, yeah.
Do you have toys?
A couple.
What do you got?
You know, dildies.
Dildies? I don't know. It sucks that you made it sound cute. Sounds like a new puppy. Like a labradoodle.
They're my pets.
Did you get the new dildies?
A couple of vibers.
A little vibies.
Vibies? It's like a Star Trek fucking
some anal beesies.
Anal beesies. What? So you...
Just stick with the vibies and the dildies.
So that's it. Is it a big dildy?
Medium. Medium to big.
What's medium to you?
A niner.
A niner. Oh. No, it is.
Jesus.
Oh, God.
I'm leaving. I'm going to leave.
You're leaving. I'm not. I'm going to stand and pull up my 4.5 pud, jerk off to a 9-inch cock. Really? All right. Well, I'm a big fan of Adam and Eve. Here's why. You don't have to go in that dumb store and the toy store. You know, they call it adult toys, and walk in and go, how much for this? I remember my
wife.
Have
Deepu's dad following you around the whole time.
All right, fuck it. We are back in the show. Let's go.
By the way, Will just texted me.
Who's Will?
Sylvans.
He's dead to me.
Will goes, sorry, .. Not going to make it.
Thank God. Adrian just put the headphones back on. All right, that was pretty, I mean, look, man, that was pretty fucking epic to have those people come in this room, Estee to walk in this room and explain, you know, just to say that, you know, for you're a comic or people wondering, it's a pretty hard thing to get into this club. I mean, the list is long. And for her to, you know, explain the process, and the, look, I had to do it. 5-minute spot. I think I was following. Oh, who the fuck was it? Somebody just denied. I think it was Jay Moore just fucking, he's a monster. Just killed it. And she was like, okay, go ahead. And I'm like, fuck it. Let's just do it. And this is really too, though. You know you did good when she's still there when you're done. If you look up and she's gone, she's not in the hallway. Yeah, don't go up and find her. Don't go up and go, what did you think? Well, I wasn't there. I left halfway through a 5-minute set. What do you think? But
how long ago was it?
That was a long time ago.
Was that stool humping days?
Yeah, I used to fuck when I fucked the stool. And they didn't have a stool. That's how I got out of it.
You
didn't
own.
Go to the mic stand?
I brought my own stool. Yeah. Hey, dude, can you bring this up when you bring it? Yeah. Can you bring the stool?
That's how the host, yeah.
Yeah. I fucked the stool. And this guy Maceo used to do a thing where he used to pretend it was a beer stein. And then Patrice goes, ah, shit, you drank out of the beer stein that Bobby fucked. Yeah, it was crazy back then. But that's pretty ugly. The show the other night was fucking nuts. It was weird to see all these guys hanging out the way we hang out. I mean, Louis was down there with notes. Romana was fucking laughing, just listening to Stewart. And, you know, Alan went up, Havy, and... It was fucking epic. I mean, I just didn't even talk. Kind of like the way you guys were when they entered the room. I've never seen...
I'm pretty sure I peed my pants.
This shut down. This room shut... You guys...
Terrifying.
Shut.
Yeah, what am I supposed to do?
What are you, Zach, tell me what you're scared about. Are you a stand-up comedian too, right?
Yeah, I do stand-up.
Okay, and you're new, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty new.
Like, how new?
Like 4 years new, so not that new.
Okay, 4 years new. That's pretty new. Dude, that's fucking new. That's so weird that comics think they have to be some type of, you know, you have, dude, that's new. 10 years is maybe where you should be fucking starting the middle headline. So you have like 6 more years to become a working comedian. I mean, fuck you, 4 years. I mean, I did it in 3. But the thing is, that's goddamn new. So you're just petrified, right?
Of them, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah, that was petrifying. 100%.
Yeah. Oh yeah, oh my God. Sitting next to the guy that screamed in my face every night when I used to sell tickets for CB's Comedy Club down the street.
Oh, thank God.
You're lucky he has Asperger's and he didn't
remember.
Oh,
I know. Thank God. Thank God his ego wouldn't allow me to stay in his memory.
Oh, my God. You're that guy?
I used to stand on the corner of Bleecker and McDougal. I ran. I worked the door at CB's Comedy Club.
Now, be honest. Were you told to come up here and get people before they went into the cellar?
Oh, no. They told us we weren't allowed. And the exact words we were supposed to say is, hey, it's right over there. If for any reason you don't get in or it's sold out, come back and talk to me. I wasn't even allowed to pitch.
Really?
If they said they were going in the cellar. And I ran that team and I told the guys that very specifically, and I fired people for trying to steal people from the cellar.
No shit.
Now, I took it very seriously because I respect these guys.
Is that an earring in your lip?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I thought it was a mole and it kept moving. I was going to throw up. I was like, just pluck it off.
Oh, you should see the one through my dick.
Oh, yeah, you got to see his Prince Albert.
Jesus, that's the most excited I've ever seen Scopo.
I'm sorry, I got to see it, dude.
Yeah.
Do you want to see it on my phone or you just want to see it?
I don't know. What's better, live?
I mean, do you want to see my hard dick on my phone or do you want to see my tiny pud in real life? What's your pleasure?
I think that's a question for you, not me.
I don't give a shit. I'll take my dick out on the show. Why don't we ask the very nice female so that she...
I'm just concerned when you go down on a girl what that thing does to her.
Yeah. Well, let's see it before you fucking judge it. Well, it's not. I'm sure it's not. It's not from the movie Seven.
It's pretty gross.
Can I have the bandana, please? Really? The fucking haven't knife.
Don't try to save it.
I really don't try to save it. So, all right. Look, can we not? I can't show it on the camera.
We can show everything but his dick if you want. Like, we get everyone's reaction.
Yeah, I want everybody's reaction but his dick.
Of course. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Right.
Wait, he's showing his real dick, or?
Oh, yeah.
No, he'll show his dick, yeah.
How can you see it?
I'm not going to look.
Wait. No, the microphone's in the way. Move over a little bit. Yeah. No, wait, stop fucking going on. Put it back.
What the fuck?
Go that way. I want you to go that way. Show the fans. Let the fans see.
What the fuck?
Show the fans. Turn to them. No, turn to that guy.
No.
It's so hard.
Put it away. Put your dick away.
Oh my God,
oh my God,
Adrian, you miss being here.
I'm good.
Oh, sorry, the Sam Robert. I know, no, the fuck off.
How did the show go?
Sorry,
from
you guys are talking wrestling. Fucking, I got fucking wrestling dick on my phone. That's wrestling dick on your phone. That's wrestling dick.
Oh, 20 minutes ago, we had the coolest show that this show's ever had.
Yeah, and now somebody pulled his dick out.
It always goes back to dick.
It really does, no matter what happens.
Yeah, but Bob, look how good it looks on my phone, though.
Dude, what's wrong? Better. Dude, can I say something? What's wrong?
You've got a lot of head to.
What's wrong?
I'm all head.
What's wrong with the edge of your dick?
What? Everything.
Why is the helmet so shiny?
Yeah. I'm photogenic.
Turtle wax it?
Yeah. He put it through the bowling ball machine.
Did you see it?
I hid in Scopo's ass.
Okay, good.
Really quick.
Good. Don't look. Yeah, I hid in Scopo's ass. Hey, why did you get that? And what is that for? Is that just to be different?
I got it when I was like, the first time I got it, I was like 16.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I thought when I heard that was a thing you could get, I've always wanted it.
Why?
That's not an explanation.
Why?
It just seemed like something that was supposed to be for me.
You gotta realize, Zach
loved it.
Zach's a freak, so
why does that
crazy.
Make sense?
Do
that
girls sense? Like it?
Yeah, I get it. I think half the reason I ever get laid is because girls see it and they're like, all right, I gotta try that.
Are you sure really? It's not that weird beard that doesn't connect?
Oh yeah, my awful Amish fucking just bottom beard.
Yeah, but it doesn't. It doesn't connect, which is great. I think you look good. You remind me. What's that movie? Forget it. I'm not even
Seven? No, Seven's the movie where Bobby was dead at the table.
I laughed out of courtesy there.
You gotta give him that.
Can you wash your hands before you touch the mic again, by the way?
No, I'm not going to give him the bandana for that. You guys just felt bad for me. That was actually a great joke.
Never seen
you guys
Seven.
Like me. And you went, aw. That's not the one. I'm terrible with this. I just don't understand. Now, when it goes in a girl's pussy, right?
Yeah.
That could hook it. That could get something, correct?
No, it's stainless steel. It's smooth.
Yeah, but is it connected all the way through? It looks
like
it had
an opening. There's a ball through it.
But there's an opening. Is there an opening?
No, it's a there's a ball that goes in it. I just don't have it in right now.
What if it
did you lose it on the train?
No, I have it in my wallet.
Why? Zach, why? Why do you have it? Why do you have it in your wallet?
Because sometimes it gets a little too heavy when I'm wearing shorts. Because it's a big ring. It's a two-gauge ring.
Jesus.
Do they make a lighter metal?
Yeah, they make like smaller rings, but I've been stretching it over the last few years.
Why?
To have a bigger dick ring.
Oh, does it make your dick bigger? Because now I'm interested.
No, but now I have a giant thing on the end of my dick.
Oh, nice.
It gives me like an extra inch. And I need it. I need it desperately.
Do you? Not desperately. You have a nice piece. I saw it.
Thank you. You're pushing all your bush fat back.
Yeah.
I actually use these bottom three fingers to make my balls look like more dick.
Ah, smart.
We'll go through it later. Yeah.
I don't understand. When a girl sees that, do you have to tell them first, right?
Most of the time, I bring that up, as I did here. I bring it up pretty quickly.
So you bring it up like I have a big fucking. Can I tell you, dude? You're absolutely right about that. Making girls want to see your cock, and once your dick's out, I mean, it's kind of game over. Once your dick's out. I told a girl, she was a big, big girl. I was in acting class.
How big?
Me right now?
Yeah.
Right now. Back then, that was sexy, Bob. Me right now?
Right.
Probably two of me.
No.
So a big, big girl.
Like obese.
So did they.
Why don't you fucking watch your tone, okay? You got a lot of fucking chubby dudes in here, okay? Not everybody's big bone.
Was it the 1,000-pound girl?
No, not 1,000. No. It was she was big. Let's put it this way.
Did they forklift her into the class?
No. We're at her apartment. When she sat on the couch, she became the couch. Like, she literally would just become part of the couch. And I remember we were doing the scene together, and I know she wanted to fuck around. And I was like, hey, I got a cock ring. She was like, no, you don't. And I was like, I got a cock ring. She's like, let me see it. I'm like, you don't want to see it. And she's like, I want to see it. Just let me see it. I go, all right. And I pulled up it was just my dick, though. I don't have one. And then she just started sucking it. Shit,
I could have just done that. This has all been for naught.
No, you need shiny shit on your dick. You should actually get a fucking a weather vane on the end of that thing.
What do you think the percentage of?
But you saved him from that. Was a bomb right there.
I still
saved him from that one.
I fucking have it. I'm looking out for you, Bob.
Yeah,
I first went right over it.
No, we didn't. Right, we superseded it. We don't have time. All right.
I'm looking out for my dad. What do you think the percentage of when your dick is out that it gets sucked or fucked?
Sucked at this point, I have to take the ring out because it's too big and girls will hurt themselves.
Interesting.
So really?
Yeah, it comes right out though.
Now it's all healed up, so there's no gook.
Yeah, I've had it for years and years.
There's no gook, though.
No, not at all.
Never any gook.
No, it heals quick. It's the first few weeks after I'd originally gotten it, you're supposed to wait like a month or two to fuck, and I fucked raw 2 days after, and it was like I put my dick in battery acid. It sucked.
Oh, my God, because it was an open wound. Dude, that's fucking just, dude, I mean, you could have got really sick from that.
Yeah, it was terrible. But I was 17. I mean, I was a dummy.
Have you ever banged a girl with a clip ring?
Yeah, and we clink them. It's cute.
Do you get caught or no?
No.
No? All right.
You did bang a girl with a clip ring.
Of course.
Is that your thing? How old are you?
28.
28. And where are you from?
I'm from Jersey.
Jersey.
Oh, me too.
Are you interested in clock rings? I guess that shit does work. That's fucking nuts, dude.
Do you like fat guys with pierced dicks and girlfriends that don't listen to the show?
Sure thing.
I would never, ever do anything to my dick. Ever, ever in a million. Sam, would you ever? You couldn't.
I got circumcised when I was 19 years old, but beyond that,
whoa,
no.
Why?
Why?
It was time.
You kept sending the moil home. Maybe tomorrow we'll try it.
Did you?
Yeah, I'm not ready. All right, let's do it. Did a girl turn you down? And you were like, I have to do it now? No. Well, I mean, I think you know this, Bob.
I forget everything. I'd like to know. I have a 2-year-old.
I've been thinking, because I have a weird dick. It's uncircumcised. Yeah, I've got a bad dick.
Wait a minute, stop. I don't understand what a bad dick is.
I'll explain if you'll let me.
Well, you were going to skim over it.
No, I wasn't.
All right, go ahead.
I'm uncircumcised, right? I'm Greek, so, you know, just to keep with my countrymen, they kept me uncircumcised. And I've got like a turtleneck dick where the head will pop out just a little bit.
Let me tell you something.
Yes.
My foreskin didn't stretch out. It was probably very similar. Yeah, like nothing. So the head didn't come out of the foreskin at all.
Mm.
So the foreskin would just stretch with it when I got erect. You understand?
Right.
So your dick was meant to be bigger?
It was stunted.
Your dick.
It was like a Japanese woman's feet being bound.
Your dick.
My
smoked.
Penis was bound. Yeah.
Dick binding. I like that. I'm gonna start telling girls that's what happened.
Okay. Yeah, and they said, you know, that there was nothing. I mean, physically, there was obviously something wrong, but there was nothing like medically wrong, but there could be. Like, it's not necessarily the healthiest thing.
So you pissed in your own dick.
We just so like when you piss. I don't know if this happens to you, mm-hmm. but when I pissed back then. Mm. Just sure. so you know. Back then, not now.
Sure.
Just for the first 19.
Sure.
When I pissed back then, like, you'd piss and the foreskin would blow up like a balloon.
Ooh, no way.
No, mine's not that
bad. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't know. You're backing out now?
I'm 50%, I think. That's why. I don't want to get. So much of my identity is I'm uncircumcised. So I don't want to.
I mean, but that's like,
not a good identity.
That's terrible.
Pretty good. Also, it looks like it's all shaft, so it's an optical illusion. They think there's head coming, but there isn't.
Right, right.
You know what
right.
I mean?
So they think that more dick is coming.
There's a phantom head there that never comes. Yeah. I like that. But I don't know. I don't want
to
get.
Do you have to shuffle it back and have it pop out?
Sometimes it pops out, ugh. You know, depending.
Does it make a sound?
Yeah, it goes. No, it'll pop out and that hurts, baby.
Why?
I don't know.
Don't you have to clean it?
Because the thing is too small. Because the opening in the foreskin is too small.
Yeah.
You got to get circumcised.
I don't want to, though.
It's ridiculous. It's not your identity.
And I can't fuck for like a while, right? If you get it circumcised.
But did you ever get like a spoon and have to like pry it out?
A spoon? What the fuck? How big is it?
You think I could fit a spoon in there, but I can't get my dick out of it?
How big is your hole that your head doesn't come out?
Now or then?
Then.
It was like the size of. Pretty much a, I mean, it was slightly larger than like your urethra.
Ooh,
like it was small.
Oh my
dude,
god!
So you're
in the foreskin.
So you're like a balloon. With it. Like a balloon.
And it would balloon up when you piss. Yeah.
Oh no.
It's so called. Dr. Steve said it's called phimosis.
Phimosis, right?
That's yeah. what it is.
I'll tell you what it's called. Some phimosis.
Right.
It's disgustingness.
Right.
It's fucking.
Okay. Well, look. We all have things that we go through.
I like saying thank you this at the end of it.
But here's what I want to know, Zach. You might know. Can I gauge my foreskin to make it like stretch out? You know how there's like I feel like you'd be a guy with weird.
You
ear,
can.
You
they
know
have,
what I mean?
They have a thing that you can weights you can hang from
really?
Your dick. You can actually if you got circumcised.
I don't want to do
they
that.
Have this process that you hang weights from your dick, your skin, and it will actually bring your foreskin back.
Ooh.
So you could be uncircumcised again.
I don't miss it.
Because they say some people think that you're not supposed to be circumcised. That's the way you're made, and it's for a reason, and we did that for vanity reasons or some shit, and it's religious. So you like you now when you saw
it's
your
much
dick,
better
when you saw your dick was like did it have like a weird farmer's tan? You know what I mean?
Was it looked like Neapolitan ice cream?
Yeah. Yeah. Was it a different color when it came?
No. Well, I mean, I don't.
From being in the shade for 18 years.
I don't go nude tanning, so.
So, but was it weird to see your helmet?
It's very strange at first, and also it was very sensitive.
Sensitive.
Mm. It was very, very sensitive.
A good
sensitive.
Kind?
Yeah, I mean, it was very sensitive to the touch.
Really?
Oh. You understand?
So, is it so still? Like,
is it?
I mean, to some degree, but not to. Are you flirting? Or
yeah, I know you're his
he's
guy.
Your guy.
He's honest guy. Like all
he, wants a, he wants a promotion.
Yeah.
But
are you gonna fluff it for him, you fucking asshole?
I mean, there are exercises you could do though. If you go, you should go to a urologist, and there are exercises that like you're supposed to pull the foreskin like every day to try to stretch it. And I'm like, I'm not doing the exercises. Just cut the shit off. Just get rid of it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
They wanted you to do fucking exercises.
That's what I said. I'm like, I'm not doing all that.
Oh my God.
My guy just wanted to get me to get it chopped off, and I'm not for it.
Can I see?
When you say your guy.
it was Adrian.
Adrian
yeah.
No, can I see it?
Can you see my dick?
Yeah.
I don't want to.
Why do you want to see everybody's dicks today?
Yeah.
Dude,
you're all horned up over there.
I created a monster. But there is a... You
I really am a fucking fat queen. Can I see some dicks? Hey, guys on the couch, did you see it? No, get him a look. Get him a turn around. Keep it out longer. What the fuck?
But you say it's sensitive. It actually takes me like... way longer to come. So I think if I got circumcised,
I
would come real quick.
At first, but then you get used to it.
You think so?
You just gotta do your Kegel exercises then.
Mm-hmm.
What's what the fuck are you talking about?
Strengthens your vagina.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But can you do it for your dick hole?
Do you do
it right now.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
Really?
Yeah.
They're easy.
They're easy. Anyone can do it.
Yeah. Adrian does it with his asshole.
I'm doing it with my asshole, right?
You are?
It's so much. How do you do it with your dick? When I try...
It's the same muscle that you use to cut off your piss midstream. That's how you find it.
Isn't that all?
Mm. Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm doing it right now. My dick is like.
I think
bouncing.
Everyone's.
Yeah, it strengthens your pelvic floor muscle. Nice.
Really?
Yeah. How many do I do? How many?
I have a weight that they sent to us.
Four sets of ten.
That's serious. That you can use.
For what?
For my dick.
For what?
A cock weight.
To
strengthen your pelvic floor muscle.
Adrian likes to do all the dick toys that they send. Adrian likes to bring them home and try.
Hey, you gotta
what's the craziest dick toy you've used?
I mean, not that crazy, but I got a Fleshlight last week or the week before that. The
fucking worst thing ever.
Yeah, it's too much work.
It's the worst. I'll tell you why. They haven't fucking. They need to. You know, remember that movie where they sprayed dog shit and it went away?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Envy.
Yeah.
They need to do that with jizz, so we can start. Because there's nothing worse than coming in. A fucking and then, dude. The
You're
worst
covered.
The worst part is you jizz in this thing, right? And then you gotta clean that Fleshlight.
Mm-hmm. You gotta wash it.
You have
like
to
dishwasher.
I don't even like doing dishes. Never mind fucking a vagina. Yeah. And you have to take it out of that thing. And it sounds like you're digging a real vagina out of a woman. Just
yeah.
And you, and then you fucking flop it and then
Yeah, it's too much work. You gotta get it warm, and then you gotta lube yourself, lube the Fleshlight, fuck it, cum in it, clean yourself.
I'd
rather just wipe off in the shower.
I like the cock ring. That's good.
What's that?
The cock ring. It's like a vibrating. You put it on your dick.
Yeah, they sell that with.
I've never used one of those.
And then you put it on. And then when if you're about to cum, you just stop, and just the vibrator goes on the girl's clit, so she's still getting off.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
While you're just
doesn't work.
You're fucking going back.
I'll tell you what, if you're ever in a jam, if you're ever in a jam with a chick, and look, when I used to bang. I used to love.
This is the best Adam and Eve read I've ever heard in my life.
Oh yeah, when I used to love, making a chick come, because I didn't have a fucking 9-incher.
What's that like?
It takes a while, but it's worth it. I had a nice piece, but I didn't have a fucking big 9. So I used to like to get them so horned up and just eat their pussy and make them come. But if you're in a jam, electric toothbrush. toothbrush,
Bristol
and
lash.
All you need is a fucking Ziploc or some plastic over the top so you can use it again. You don't want to waste it, right? And you put that right on a clitoris, she'll lose her fucking mind. Lose her mind. Yeah, just like a vibrator. Fucking jizz fucking all over the place.
This is a woman? Jizz?
Anything sold.
Are you fucking a man? Is that
No, women jizz, man. Women have jizz, right?
Yeah, they do.
They squirt, but it's known
pee,
that
right?
It's pee. Yeah. Yeah.
It's
women
urine.
Don't have cum?
It no,
cum?
It's pee.
Yeah.
No.
And sperm, right?
No, you know what? It is pee. I think it is pee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you got pissed on, is what happened.
Yeah, so what?
Yeah.
So what?
Not my thing, but
so when
you
cum, what is it? Nothing?
I don't think it's anything, really. I think it's
just
God
juice.
Thank God it's not the eggs.
Tasty.
Yeah.
It's not the fucking actual egg from her.
It's like
youth.
Fucking caviar.
Yeah, just
an egg yolk comes out.
A fucking salmon running in Alaska. Yeah, dude, I used to love making. There's nothing better. I used to think just getting your dick sucked and me cum was great. There's nothing better than horning a girl up to the point where they have to suck your dick.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
Like they're just like, well, you ever see a girl turn into like a fucking gorilla?
Yeah.
They just start. And just a nice smile would go over my face.
I mean, there's nothing better than when you're the first guy that ever ate a girl's ass, and they're like,
yep.
"What are you doing?"
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
They're like, "What is this?"
Yeah.
I fucking love this kid.
Yeah.
Not only are you fucking fun to look at. I mean, hey, Jesus Christ. Dude, I remember the girl, one of my first girlfriends. I gotta stop. I forgot. Not that I'm popular at all, but I'm a little more popular than I used to be. And things that I say now get back to people. I'm that, you know what I mean? So I have to make sure I don't say people's names anymore. Because I used to just say names, and then now I'm starting to get emails. Dude, you fucking said my chicks. We have a family, and it's like I forget. Like all these fucking whores I fucked.
They grew up.
Like grandparent, you know, my grandchild told me you said you fucked in my ass, and I sucked your dick right after. I did ass to mouth. Yeah, I can't.
Probably fucked some chick at the Comedy Connection at her bachelorette party, and now this guy's finding out. Give it back to me. Give it to me.
You'll fucking make it a cock ring. But the I ate this girl's ass out. I knew she never did it. Most girls were just at that age. It was like 20 something or 19, whatever the fuck. Most girls at that age. Just fuck, suck, titties. That's it. Mm-hmm. You make out, you rub her pussy, take a titty out, then you take your dick out, then she sucks your dick, you eat some pussy, and then you fuck. Then you do doggy style, and then you're done.
That's pretty standard.
My move was make out, get a titty, eat some pussy, and then eat that ass. Fucking eat that ass.
Like a lot. I'll take a swipe, but you're talking.
I'm like the guy on Fear Factor that eats the goat uterus and and then sticks his tongue out. What else you got?
Yeah. Yeah, my move was I skip door number one, and while making out with the chick, I'll go to grab her ass and have my middle finger graze the butthole. Yeah. And if she goes, and I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, that was an accident. But if she backs into it, completely skip door number one and start fingering her ass.
There's, oh, my God. This
right to the ass.
Well, I mean,
jeez,
you kind of, you don't want to stick your finger in and then smell it and then go. You got because you won't go. You will not go.
Just bring a clothespin with
that's
you,
like
put it over your nose.
Having a fear
just don't smell it. Just
that's
go.
Like having a fear of fights and then looking down. You don't want to fear of flight. So don't look down. You don't fuck. You go. Okay. You just go into that and you lick the stink right off of it. You know.
You smell your top lip on the subway right home.
That's why I never grew a mustache. But you go down on a chick's butt. Yeah, that's why, girls, if you ever see us, if we're licking your pussy and licking your ass, and then we lick your inner thigh, we're licking what off and trying to get it on your inner thigh because you fucking smell. Fucking waitress twat.
Sometimes you have to lick the knee because it has more folds and get it off quicker.
I just did a double shift at fucking Applebee's. I'm licking that fucking Mexican stink off, riblet stink off your pussy. But yeah, dude, I used to love you. I remember I ate her ass. And I remember I was eating her pussy, and then I ate her ass. And I know I'm whispering, but I like to do that. Mm-hmm.
You're getting me
high. I remember she went, she was holding her pussy open. And then I remember she moved her hand down like a spider. It kind of just went like that to her ass, open, and went, and I went, she fucking turned into just a fucking angry, just a mean bully.
I hate that.
I love that. I love when a girl.
It intimidates me. I can't do it.
Oh, when a girl gets fucking, you fucking bitch.
No, I'm too gentle. I can't.
I love gentle too, but I love fucking you mother, feet that asshole. I love turning to go, oh my God, we shouldn't fucking eat that. You fucking pussy.
Dude, I want to be gasping for air like a fucking fish at the bottom of a boat.
There's no, because once you do that to a girl, once you get her fucking, you know, then I don't feel guilty. Then they just want, I want to.
Yeah.
Give me, you ever have a girl go, give me that dick. I mean. Yes. Yeah, right? It's like, fucking, now we're on the same fucking plane.
And we're just animals.
No,
we're level.
Too much pressure.
Yeah. We're level because when it's always the guy, like, I'm going to, you know, we're so great. And they're like, I don't know. Oh, God, please stop. When you get a girl riled up where she says, fuck it. I mean, let's say this. You need to give a girl an excuse.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? A good girl needs an excuse to be a bad girl. That's it. Your job is to give her the excuse that she needs to fucking, and when you eat a girl's ass, you give her the, I'm fucking, I'm already past the point. He ate my ass. Now I'm sucking dick. You gave her the excuse that she needed so that, you know, I couldn't control myself. It was so, oh my God, I had no control. I didn't know what I was doing. So, right?
But that scares guys sometimes.
I forgot there was a girl in the room. Yeah. Like, what do you mean?
It does. If you're too much, it will scare them. I've scared guys away.
You've scared guys?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
No, first of all, you're dealing with fucking assholes.
Yeah. That scares boys away.
Yeah. I'm such a boy. Yeah,
that's my type.
Were you trying to eat his ass in musical theater? No. I don't understand it. What do you mean, scared?
I don't know. I think it. They feel emasculated and it scares them sometimes.
Although that is kind of cool.
It's like a competition. You got to go over them.
Yeah.
Exactly. Because now I want to get the fuck out of here. I'm your bitch.
Yeah. You go over the top. Yeah.
Exactly.
I tell you this. I don't know how I'm going to get emasculated when I'm all fours going to eat my pussy. you're crazy. You're crazy. That's the greatest thing ever. Girls think that if you suck our dicks, and we're gonna think you're a whore. No, you're not. We're gonna love you.
That's the best.
Look, what's the problem when you meet somebody? Do you like me, and do I like you? You're sitting there, girl's sitting there going, I don't know if he likes me, and I'm sitting there going, I don't know if she likes me. If you suck my dick and I eat your pussy, we like each other.
Pretty clear sign.
It's a pretty clear sign. Yeah. No, I'm not going to say we're going to get married. That's why I have that joke in my act. I mean, if my wife sucked my dick on a rock for an ice cream on our first date, if she didn't do that, I wouldn't have Max.
So sucking dick brought your family together.
Dude, abso-fucking-lutely.
She was just impressed he gave up an ice cream.
That was good, but that was sexy, Bobby, by the way. I didn't eat ice cream.
Wait, what were you doing? You holding the ice cream here? And I'm like, you're like my dick.
Yeah, no, yeah.
You get two scoops.
Yeah, Don got hypnotized by a fucking soft serve. God, you're fucking dumb. No, we. How are you? She following you to the beach?
Well, the way the joke is, like, she took like four ice cream. So she had ice cream, and she was like, I have to suck your
dick. Yeah, she really liked ice cream.
We went and had an ice cream. I didn't take her to dinner or a movie. We just had an ice cream, and she blew me. So, you get it?
It's a good date.
Yeah, so she sucked my dick for an ice cream. I basically just gave her an ice cream and she blew me. It wasn't like I gave her flowers.
Sprinkles?
Yeah.
Just to cover up the flavor.
I just want to make sure you get the joke
I
think Scopo thought you held the ice cream in front of your dick, and then when she went for it, you're like, ah, gotcha.
Yeah, I tricked her. Yeah.
This is a warm ice cream.
Flesh pop.
Never had this flavor.
Why does your ice cream smell like a foot? yeah, dude. So I think it's the exact opposite. Now, do you have rules? When you go with a guy. I know you're married now.
No, I know. Back in the day.
You make sure you get your dates right. Yeah. Last week I stuck. Wait a second.
Nah. I would do it, whatever.
Really?
Yeah. Take me to 7-Eleven, buy me a burrito. I don't care.
I don't want to get blown by a chick with burrito breath. I don't want my dick to smell like fucking nachos.
I don't know about asshole eating after a 7-Eleven burrito.
Could you imagine that? Just goes right through her. You can smell beer and cheese. That's fucking gross.
Why'd we stop at White Castle?
So you just, no rules. Just
no
fuck
rules.
It.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Great. Fuck, why is she married? How great would it be if she was just single talking like that? I
pretty good.
I fucking do. You don't
Estee walked in during the wrong part of this show.
Oh my god!
How awful would it have been if they had both come up while my dick was out? By the way. Hi, I'm Zac. I'm a comedian. Nice to meet you guys.
I was just at
Estee looks at us and goes, "You want Friday show?
I was up at JFL 42 up in Toronto, which I was a little apprehensive about because it was a little weird going into it. But it was fucking a great festival.
Was it weird?
I just didn't get, like, JFL, you know, the Montreal JFL, I've been done a million times. I've done the tour. This one was a little weird. It's a little more independent-ish, you know. Everybody does an hour.
Oh, wow.
And then there's the big headliners and then whatever, and then there's all these hour shows. So it's not like JFL regular Montreal. You're doing galas, which is like 8-minute sets on TV, or you're doing a 15-minute nasty show or relationship show. You don't really do hours. It's just you're on these showcases. But this, everybody there, there's 42 comics that do an hour.
Whoa.
So we're all over the city. So you're at the Comedy Bar, which is one of my favorite rooms in the world. Then I did Rivoli's, which is great. That's when Kids in the Hall started. This other place. But anyways, it was awesome. But a lot of, you know, Verzi was up there, which I fucking love. Verzi's the best. If you have a common enemy with Verzi, there's nobody better to go, what do you think about this guy?
Oh, he goes off. So much fun.
All he needs you to go is fucking, I don't like him. Fucking me neither. Fucking cock. You know, it's so great. And then...
Doing your voice?
Huh?
A little more high-pitched, yeah.
I'm at the Comedy Bar. We're all back there. Me, Rob Mayhew, who killed it all week, too. I love that kid. He in the back room, he put on this fucking Tails, like Steve Perry from Journey used to wear. You know, like a short jacket with the tails with sparkles on the shoulder and fucking tassels on the sleeves. And we all were like, you don't have the balls to wear that on stage. And we bullied him into wearing that in one of his sets. And we were just kidding. I would have never done it. I would have been like, fucking suck my dick. I'm not falling for your horseshit. He fell for it, wore it for a nice 15-minute set. Looked like a fucking, just an asshole magician on stage. Right? So we're all in the back. Rob, bunch of comics. Rob's girlfriend, who is the nicest girl ever.
Smoking hot, too.
Smoking hot, nicest girl ever. She's just sitting right by the door as you walk in. Ari comes in with his fucking dick out. Literally fucking cock high right next to her cheek. Kind of walks by. And then he sees her and goes, oh, shit, sorry. Fucking greatest thing ever. I had a fucking blast up there, though. What a cool festival. Great time. And we did my podcast up there. We did the live YKWD. Mm-hmm. Brian Posehn, Al Magical,
Rob
Mayhew, and Arthur Simeon. And I didn't know. It was fucking great. Unbelievable. Fucking great show.
What about what happened on Twitter?
Trending.
The hashtag. Mm-hmm. You know what, dude? Was that just a coincidence, or was that...
We trended.
Trended.
That was crazy.
You don't believe in the show, Deepu? What's going on? What mistake happened where this show got attention from people?
I'll tell you what it is. It was an... I'm not going to fucking lie. It wasn't that we were trending.
They posted a picture of my tits, and then they started trending.
I can't gauge your boobs. I don't know if they're real or they're...
Oh, they're so real.
Yeah, but...
I wish they were fake.
But I don't know if they're big or small.
That's the most Jersey thing you
can see. They vary.
Hang on. Sometimes they're small.
I know.
Like, I feel like if I see them one time, I'm going to be like this. And then if... And then another time...
Yeah.
Wow, good joke.
This is the Morning Zoo with Robert Kelly. Also, thanks for listening to Riotcast. We bring you free entertainment every week. Right back at you.
Also, Bob,
Dan?
Who are you kidding that any situation where you saw her tits, you would be mad?
I would be. Because if I, absolutely, if I think a girl's tits are one way and then they're another, it fucking grows. No. It bugs me.
I'll take titties. Mm-hmm.
Because
the nipples goes in, and they're not
inverted
always hard.
Are
yeah,
the worst.
Those are the worst.
No, I like a nice inverted nip.
Inverted nipples. Ugh. It was gross.
You a what?
I knew a girl with inverted nipples. It was disgusting.
How often did you look at them?
A couple of times a week.
Nice.
I tell you, I went with a girl one time. She had her nipples were an inch long.
I don't like that.
I'll take them inverted.
Dude, I didn't like it at first.
You just licked your lips so
that's
hard.
Like Guinness, that's Guinness World Records long.
Buddy,
holy shit.
No, like milking
this,
a cow.
Like that? Yeah.
No.
That weirds little me stiff. Out too, yeah.
Dude, I freaked out. I'm not kidding. Listen, I freaked out. I took her, this is a long time ago. I have to date these things because I'm married. A long time ago, my uncle's just built this house up in New Hampshire. I took her up there, just me and her. I remember we're making out. She took her shirt off. I literally went, whoa! I fucking was scared. And she goes, I know, I was going to tell you. Like,
I've done this way before.
Yeah, dude. I mean, huge, man. Like light switches.
Did milk come out?
No, thanks.
Did milk come out?
Did you start playing with them just go like this?
Dude, you could bend them. Like, bend them over. Dude, I love that. I was a little grossed out at first, but then I was just, all of a sudden I was just like, fuck. And then I put one in my mouth. It was like a little...
It's
like
the best
baby dick
to just chew on. Yeah,
that's what you go for, baby dick.
No, but
it was so hot. It was like a child's penis in my mouth. Welp, is that a bomb? I think I got one.
No,
that
was just it was too much baby dick. Yeah, I got uncomfortable.
Like I'm the asshole. You brought it up.
I did one. We got a little chuckle. Then you said baby dick three more times.
You made it real.
Then it was just baby
fuck
dick.
Off, dickheads.
Yeah.
That was,
It was. I love big nipples. Mm-hmm. I love it, but I just don't like when it's. You know, it's like a chick when she takes her titties out and they're. You ever see like after kid titty?
No.
Yeah. A little.
Thank God. Well, no.
I don't mind if it's an after kid titty. If you tell me that, look, my titties are a little saggy, or I had a kid. I don't mind that. But if I'm visualized, it's like, hey, I'm drinking milk. Oh fuck, it's orange juice. That thing where it's just mentally like fuck. Now I'm not having anything.
Like when all the titties at the bottom, and then it's just like a sock with a water balloon in it.
I don't mind that if you tell me. If I can fucking psychologically be ready for an awful titty,
What about like a teardrop titty?
Love a teardrop titty.
I'll take teardrop. That's nice.
I'll take a teardrop. What kind of titty do you like there, Eric?
Eddie.
I like the teardrop titty.
That's your why did you say it like a serial killer?
No, sorry.
I like to cut them out. Eddie, what do you do?
That's a lot of things.
Oof. I'm a freelance writer.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that it?
That's about it. I also gamble on baseball games. That's what I do.
That's
for
your
a
career?
Living.
Well, you know, DraftKings come around in the summer. DraftKings, use the code word Kelly. Really, you gamble.
Yeah, yeah.
Baseball's tough, though.
Every night
it's different with the pitchers. That's
well,
to gamble on.
I don't really know that much about baseball. I just bet the innings, whether a team will score in an inning or not.
Do you have some kind of formula or something figured out?
Not really.
Do you make any money?
But I don't try to figure it out. I just ride with, like, if I'm being lucky or not.
Uh-huh. That seems like how you lose a lot of money.
I feel like I'm in a Bill Murray movie.
So back to my tits.
Yes. Yes. Are those your boobs right there?
Yes, they're my boobs.
Okay, great. What about you, Eric?
Those are his boobs, too.
I'm actually a crime analyst in Connecticut.
That's
yeah.
Chris,
what?
By
are
the
you
way.
Dexter?
I'm Chris, by the way.
Yeah, I know. I just said, I know. That's what I do, dude. Don't fuck up what I do.
You didn't know. You fucked it up.
I do that. I called him fucking Eric, too. I knew his name was Denny.
Your thing is calling people by the wrong name.
Yeah, that's my thing.
What's his name?
His name's Michael. Michael, the guy he owns, he has his own brand new bike line. He's doing custom bikes in Brooklyn. And he's a writer.
I do.
What do you do?
I'm a crime analyst.
What the fuck is that? Like CSI?
Kinda. Basically, we do spatial and temporal analysis on crime data. So basically, we make maps and charts and graphs and stuff like that. So
were there no crimes last night? Why the fuck are you here right now?
I took a vacation day. You know.
Yeah, they never show that in like CSI. Like, you know what I mean? Those shows that they ever get like Saturdays and Sundays off. And then you watch like the 48, the, what is that show?
First 48.
The first 48. And those guys like go home. Hey, what's up, honey? And they have like.
There's still a kid still missing out there somewhere tied up in a basement.
It's like they're barbecuing because it's their kid's birthday. In the CSI, they never fucking eat. And they never nap. They never sleep. Nothing. It's just crime all the time till they solve it. You fucking take some time off. Good for you.
Yeah. See a podcast.
Have you ever solved a crime?
I've assisted. Yeah, in that. Yeah.
Really?
We do like pattern recognition and stuff like that, so we can kind of forecast crime trends and things like that.
What the fuck does that mean?
Yeah. Well, it's based on patterns. So if we get a crime, you know, that's like burglaries or something like that, and then, you know, they're working in a pattern, you can kind of calculate out days, hours, and things like that. Yeah. So you get an idea where they're going to be, what time, things like that. Yeah.
And that probably shit works?
Yeah, we're getting better at it.
What's that? What's that?
No, I was going to say, you probably don't want to give all your strategies away.
No, it's all right. Yeah, it's
but they're not going to fucking, they're criminals. They're not going to listen to the show.
A lot of criminals like this show.
As they're robbing houses, they're listening to this, just laughing.
Dude, fucking dude right now.
Let me pick this lock.
What's the chat room saying, buddy?
Gavin says, book the Boston guy who freaked out over the baby wheel. I don't know what that means. Is that a story?
No, it's a sunfish.
Who got you that?
I did this.
Oh, nice.
It's so everybody hates it.
It's bad, yeah.
It's terrible, but I love it because it's so terrible. Get it?
It's good. It's a shtick.
Go ahead, what else you got?
He also says, Chris is a crime analyst who shops at Spencer's, apparently. Pretty good.
Yeah, touche, touche.
Apparently they don't get paid a lot over there. What else you got? He's got big fucking mitts, though. Look at his hands. The other hand. One hand smaller than the other. What the fuck's wrong with that? No, go ahead.
Monique Owens says, you were awesome at JFL, Bobby.
Oh, I got to talk about these three broads.
Yeah?
Was it Monique one of them?
Monique is one of them. Oh, yeah, wow. We have. Look, man, we always. I know we have a lot of ham bones that listen to this show. We had. I'm up at JFL. I'm doing a show. Unbelievable show up there at Rivoli's, right? Like I said before. Every show was sold out of mine, by the way. Every show was packed to the gills, which was awesome. So thank you for coming. These three girls. Oh, come out. These three hot chicks, you know, are out front. You know, and they're not like model hot. They're like fucking, you know, what I like. Mm-hmm. That, you know, regular girl. Like, you know, like Lauren hot. You know what I mean? Like regular girl hot. Like, mm-hmm. You know, you just meet her at a fucking supermarket, a Starbucks, and then, you know, eat ass in the fucking back of a Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah. I'm with it.
So, these three girls were up front. They come up. They're huge fans of the show. Now, girls say that, blah, blah, blah. These girls knew all you fucks, knows everything that goes on. They love, like, of course, they don't want to fuck me. They want nothing to do with me. They love Dan Soder and Joe List. They're in love with Joe List's small mouth for some reason. I don't know if they think.
Hey, Joe got engaged.
I'm just throwing it out there for the fans. Everyone know.
Could have waited.
Well, yeah, but that's a huge thing. Now, if I don't stop, I'm in the middle of a build-up for this whole fucking topic about these girls.
Yeah.
And you're time. You have no fucking comic or radio timing. You just think
I'm just
something.
I'm happy for my friend Joe.
Buddy, I'm happy too, and I got the show. It's on my head. I'm going to announce it. But you could have went at the end of it when we're trailing, and then oh, Joe got, and we moved the fuck on. In the middle of this, you go, Joe got engaged! Because you have no filter in your brain.
No.
You don't. You just have nice hair and a fat ass.
And lips.
You got nice lips, too. And you got that mole removed, so that's good. Yeah. And you stutter, which I like. Joe got engaged. That's the worst. It is pretty epic, man. Joe List of, and this actually, you know what? I apologize. This is going to fold in really nicely because I know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm a broadcaster like my friend Sambo. Over
Sam
there.
Never well, talks to me like that.
Because you're not a moron.
He's kind of a moron.
I'm talking about Adrian.
He's a moron. You think
he's a bit of a moron? Yeah. He's an idiot. Around.
I'll trade you Adrian for Scopo right now.
No. No, I would never do that.
We're throwing cash considerations.
You throwing what?
Cash.
Yeah. No, I'm not gonna do that.
I'll throw in an espresso machine.
Yeah.
We have a coffee machine there.
The espresso's fucking way better.
I mean, I have an espresso maker that I could just bring in.
Yeah. I'll go to Starbucks.
Yeah, that's downstairs.
Actually, you'll go to Starbucks.
Yeah, I'll send somebody to Starbucks.
I'll send an intern.
All right.
Adrian, you'll go.
You know what, Adrian? You're done on the show. I'm done with you. You know what? I don't like your attitude, and I don't like the way you're talking to me. We used to be friends, and I gave you your start. And you
I still like you a lot.
Okay. All right, you're back on the show. You're back in. All right, listen. These three broads were there. Unfucking believable. Of course, they want to bang. You know, they're like talking like, oh, just cute Joe is, and talking about your fat ass, which bugs me.
Anything about me?
No, nothing. But she's there if she likes you. Okay. But the three girls were, I mean, first of all, they were really, you know, each one of them had their own little thing that I kind of liked. And I took them off a pizza.
Nice.
What are you laughing at?
It's just the way you said that.
Oh. There's no thought behind it. Fucking hardest show I've ever done. Keep fucking adding your part of the conversation to it. We went out. I took them all off a pizza and...
pizza.
I fucking love Zach. Yeah. But in the old day, I would at least tried. I would have tried. I would have let take the rejection. And fucking, I just was like, all right, girls, got to go. Nothing. But they want nothing to do with me.
How do you know, though?
Because I know.
You do?
No.
Yeah, the way they hug me goodbye.
But you could fuck if you want to. You're nice. You're a married man. You have a nice family. Yep. But I remember in Boston, somehow you were ordering everything on the menu. You were ordering six things. And somehow still a waitress, and you're just like, just nacho cheese on your gullet, and still I could tell a waitress would have fucked you if you tried. You've got a nice little charm about you, Bob.
Well, why don't you tap me on the shoulder and let me know that when it's happening?
I will, for sure. I will not do that because you're married.
We're on video, dummy. They can see you winking.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, of course I wouldn't do anything. No, of course I wouldn't do anything. But it just feels good to be wanted.
How do you know?
Huh?
How do you know?
Because I remember back in the day, I used to fucking be wanted.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Yeah. My wife wanted me at one point, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it would have been nice that, you know, the girls were like, hey, listen, before we talk about these other guys on your show, like Dan and Joe and Scopo and Mark and fucking Phil Hanley and I mean little everybody, they're huge fans of the show. We would fuck you first, but we love your family and we respect that.
That's what you want to hear.
I don't know. I know you don't cheat, right? I'd be like, why? And they'd be like, because we really want to suck your dick and just go back to your hotel room and just fucking orgy it out with your fucking dude dick.
Right. And you're like, well, no, I don't, but it's good to know.
And then I'd be like, no, I don't. And they'd be like, oh, cool, but we would have. We wanted you to know. Now let's talk about Joe List's small mouth.
Right. Mm. Well, yeah. Stop having all these young male cutie pies on the show all the time.
How do I stop? That's all that I got around me.
You fucking did today.
Hey, how dare you? I'm adorable.
Yeah, anything? You are, it bugs me that you are fat adorable.
Thank you.
That's just because yeah.
It's my
you,
thing.
You and Zach should do a show together.
That is not. Have we hit the quota for fat guys in dumb glasses and dumb t-shirts or what? We're pretty.
You guys, it would be a great.
I was gonna wear a cat t-shirt too. I'm glad I didn't. I just got a hot dog.
We know our audience.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like Monique says,
I'm not forwarding this anymore. I'm letting you fucking try, all you guys. Like Sam, we go back and forth.
Exactly. I try to build on what you're doing, Bob.
You're tired, too,
What do you think our show
I
should
work
be,
nights
Bob?
Now.
You want a coffee?
No, I'm fine. I don't drink coffee.
What should our show be, Bob?
What's up? What does Monique say?
Monique said she would.
I tried, said what? Stop. Shush. What?
She just chimed in. She said she would fuck you.
Oh.
What about me? All right. She said something about how she, you saved her life from moving traffic. Was that a thing?
Oh, this girl. She's a beautiful, Dominican girl. You know, big titties,
Monique,
right?
Monique, what about me?
Glasses. She had glasses.
I like it. I like everything you're saying.
And so we're walking to the curb. The two girls are on my left. She's on my right. All of a sudden, this girl didn't. She just walked off the curb. She didn't see it. Like, walk. Like she was walking like into heaven. She just stepped off the curb. Like there was more sidewalk than there wasn't. And she fell to her fucking knees. in the gutter, just laughing. She was. Her nylon was ripped. Just laughing to herself, because what else are you going to do, right?
Yeah.
And a car's coming. I mean, I'm not kidding. There's fucking headlights coming. She's just cracking up at herself. These two other, her friends are just talking about whatever the fuck they're talking about. This girl, I don't know, is about to fucking be run over. At least lose a foot. And I started grabbing her, but she was. I couldn't pick her up.
Heavy is what you're saying?
No, she wasn't.
She's a bigger girl?
No, I'm saying I'm thick. Weak. Fuck all thick. You guys. Yeah. That's not, I didn't say thick.
She's just a curvaceous woman. She's
did say Dominican. So.
Yeah.
Thick is good. Yeah,
she's voluptuous is what you're telling us.
She was hot. She was
right.
Definitely hot, yeah.
Right.
She was voluptuous. And I couldn't, and I have a bad back. And we I picked her up. But yeah, well, I should have got something. I should have, you know what I mean?
Hey, saved her life.
We didn't like
but does that make you feel better that she said that she would have fucked
you? No, because she threw that thing at the end. If it was just...
She wouldn't have.
It's too late.
Yeah, what's she that? Just
said I
that.
Think she would have. I really think... I think you're underestimating yourself here, Bob.
Well, I don't even know how to get to the point. Like, because I can't go to the next rejection. If I could go to the red light, green light stage, where you throw out something to a girl and you're either going to get a red light or a green light, I would know. But I can't go to that stage because that's fucking cheating. So I have to just, hey guys, nice pizza, and see you later. But if I could be like, hey, who wants to suck this dick?
Well, you can't.
Yeah, well, if she was like, we can't. But if I could just say that and be like, hey, let's go back to my room. You guys can all suck my dick like under the cover. We'll make a tent. And you guys, my head will just be out. You guys suck my dick like it's not happening.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, you guys are camping, and my dick is the pole, and you guys just suck it.
Yeah.
And I'm outside, and I'll be pretending I'm a bear.
Right.
You guys, no, my God.
Right.
It's a very specific fantasy.
I didn't think I jerked off to that night. And then, that would be good. And they'd be like, oh, we can't do that. We don't want to do. We love you. But if they were like, let's go, then I'd at least know. And have to fight. I can't do that.
You actually could just jokingly say,
yeah, just
let's
be like,
fuck.
And then don't you wish
after
you
give them the pizza? I just here's a slice, but would you fuck me? Just do that.
That was
see
creepy.
See what they say. I'm married, but would
you
fuck
me? That's
the
way you guys do it in Queens? Hey, here's a slice of pizza. It's grandma. Would you fuck me? My name is Chris Scopo.
It works.
Why, have you ever pulled that off?
No, I've never done that. No, I used to go to girl. I used to say to girls, what would you do if I kissed you right now? And then they would go,
Oh my God.
And then they would go, we'll find out. And then I would do it. And then it would work.
That is terrible.
No.
I prefer pulling your pierced dick out to that.
Yeah, was your really your line? What are you, Prince?
Yeah.
What would you do if
I mean,
this is I know Scopo did it like this too, though. What would you do if I kissed you? And then she went like this, what?
Speak up.
Because he said it too soft.
Then he'd say, Joe got engaged. Deepu. Armor Deep on the board.
His fucking name's Armor Duba.
You knew that.
I burned it out of my memory.
Yeah. I tried to also. But.
Sam, when you met your wife, how long have you been with your wife?
10 years.
How long have you been married?
3.
How's it going?
Amazing.
Wow, you're right. You guys do have a great back and forth.
Assuming there are no follow-up questions, I'm in a constant state of marital bliss.
There are some follow-up questions.
Okay.
No, I'm serious.
That's fine.
I'm telling you, me and my wife had some hard times.
Yeah.
Especially having a kid or whatever. there's so much stress going into it. I mean, it's fucking hard. You know, you haven't had one hard spot yet?
No, tons of hard spots. Like, now.
One. Are you in a hard spot right now? What's going on? What's hard about it, dude?
We fight a lot.
Why are you fighting?
I'm not.
Is it you or her? Who do you think it is?
Who do I think it is? Her.
Yeah, he's not going to say him.
Right. Thank you, Chris Scopo. He understands me.
Why would he say it's him, though?
You don't want him to understand you. Yeah. If Scopo's on your side, you're on the wrong side.
Have you asked her what she would do if you kissed her right there? Yeah,
that's my strategy.
Is she screaming at you? What would you do if I kiss you? What? I said, What would you do if I kiss you?
No, it's...
You should try that.
What would you do if I kiss you?
I can't hear you, fucking asshole. Stop in my ear, you fucking idiot. What are you saying? Sam!
Stop breathing on me. No, it's not. I mean, it's not that. We're trying to figure out when kids works for both of us.
Having a kid?
Yeah.
You're thinking about having a kid.
I'm not. That would be the problem. And also, now that I'm doing the night shift, I'm gone all the time. So it's like we're trying to figure out how that works.
Because she works during the day.
Yeah.
What does she do again?
She works in film.
In film.
But it's like it's a 9 to 5, 9 to 6.
9 to 5 job. So she comes home when you're going in. Or you don't even see each other.
Right.
So you don't see each other 5 days a week.
Well, I mean, you know, she'll wake up when I go to bed or whatever, but that's it.
That's the problem right there, dude.
You think so?
Yeah, because you're not... Look, me and my chick just went on... This sounds fucking gay as shit, but we started date night. I have date night tonight. That's why we're doing the podcast at 2.
12.
The fuck are you laughing at, Michael?
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
No, I'm kidding.
You got to do date night.
He actually got scared.
Like, there's nothing wrong with date night.
It doesn't have to be corny.
Huh?
It doesn't have to be corny.
But it's like if you have a... We see each other, like, we go out on the weekend, we go to a movie, we do whatever. Like, we still spend time together. But if there's, like, this is the date night that you have to go on a date this night, I'm like, I don't want to do that. That's not why I'm here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
At my show?
It's too much pressure.
It's too much pressure. It's not an assignment. I don't need an assignment.
Then you feel like you have to have sex.
Exactly.
All right, but, all right, here's the deal.
Exactly. No,
what was that?
Chris Scopo walked into me.
His fucking ass is like a tank.
It's a whole convoy.
I know. The reason why, like, me and my wife weren't, I'm talking about when you have a kid, we don't see each other. Like, I go to work, she's with the kid, it's just, I'm away, and I'd be home, and we'd just be home all the time. We forgot how to be a couple.
Yeah.
We forgot how
to. We don't have kids, though.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is when you have kids.
Right, I mean, I don't.
I'm trying to get out of this.
Okay.
Just allow me away out of my shitty advice.
Okay.
On date night.
Because I don't have kids. So there's no reason.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying.
It doesn't apply to me.
All right, let's just move on. Yeah, let's just move on.
Your advice doesn't
work. Oh, I
thought
you meant when
I heard Joe got engaged.
Yeah. Like.
Shut up. No, he didn't.
Oh, really? Yeah, dude, you, so you're just fighting right now.
Yeah.
Is it just on weekends? What, are you happy at all?
Do you have fight night?
Yeah, we have a fight night.
That's what I'm suggesting.
Where we get our feelings out. And we fight with each other. I mean, sometimes we still have a good time. But when we don't have a good time, we're fighting.
So she wants a kid.
She does. And but it doesn't make any sense right now.
You don't want a kid. How old are you?
32.
You shouldn't have a kid right now.
That's what I'm saying, right?
You really should. I'll tell you what you do. Because you're married to your fucking work, as you should be.
Right.
You are married right now to your job. And you were married to your job before you were married to her. Mm-hmm. We said this on the show before.
Yes.
You need to... So your first woman is your career.
Right.
And you're trying to get that going, which is a slow, slow grind. But you,
all right. I mean, I'm doing pretty well.
But now... Right. Let me finish.
Oh.
Now you're almost there.
Almost.
Right?
Closer.
You went from a fucking intern to a producer... To having your own show on the not once a day or once a week, to having your own show once a day. Now at night you have your own time slot,
right?
Which is pretty fucking amazing in this day and age in radio,
right?
Now you're trying to make that bigger and get it to where you need it to go, and that's going to take around 5 to 10 years to get where you want to be. It's going to take a while to get there. It just takes time,
of course.
Yeah, it takes time. Anything takes time.
Right, because you have to be very, very good at it. And you don't get good at it until you do time.
She's panicking because she's seeing everybody with kids.
Of course, but I'm trying to tell her she's on Facebook. All her friends that have kids, though, they're working these fucking mundane jobs. They have nothing going on.
Mm-hmm.
So of course you gotta have a kid because your life is boring.
Right.
You know?
It's hard. It's hard. You know, it's hard because you think you're missing out. But right. You're over here going, fuck, if I do this, I'm gonna fuck my career up.
Exactly.
I'm not gonna be able to come home. I don't have enough money. You know, and whatever she makes at her job, she's gonna have to start using that to pay a nanny.
Right, yeah, because we're not home.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. It's not the time. It's not the time.
It's not the time.
But Bobby, you and I are logical thinkers. That's what makes us so great.
But I knew when the time came, I was still scared.
You were?
Yeah, a little bit, man. I knew it was coming. But then there was a point one that I remember I asked her, you want kids? She goes, up until she was like, I don't know, 38, whatever the fuck she was like, no, I don't want kids at all.
Right.
So we were both like, fuck kids. Ugh, parents. We used to, when we went to Aruba once or twice a year, we'd see parents at the airport, and we used to go, fuck them. they just look wet. You know what I mean? They're just all carrying shit.
She's like, that's the bad part. Like, that's where I'm at now. Oh. I'm like, you believe that? Fuck them, right? And she's like, no, they look like they're having a great time. I wish I would. I'm like, oh, shit. Well, yeah, I shouldn't have even brought it up.
Well, I asked her, I was, you want kids? She was like, I think I might. I was like, oh, fuck. But
you shouldn't have asked.
But then there was I was ready.
You wanted it.
You know, right when I hit 39, 40, I was like, I'm ready. I'm done. Because I knew it would take me to the next level of right. life. Mm-hmm. And well, in our business, to let go of the fear that you think that, you know, it's going to somehow take away, it doesn't. It actually, it makes you a harder worker. It makes things better because you have to.
Right.
You know, but that's only at a certain time.
I could see getting there in years.
Yeah, years.
Years down the road.
I'd love to see a little hairy Sam.
You would? I mean, I wouldn't. You know, I wouldn't let you around him because when I was younger, you had an affinity for me. So I wouldn't want you.
That just sounds weird.
No, I mean it was fucking weird.
No, what was weird?
Like it was supposed to sound weird because it was weird.
Was it weird that I had that for you, or you actually played into it?
Okay, I was trying to get ahead in the business.
Oh, really?
I was lied to.
What are you, Pia Zadora? That was a great reference. Fuck you. I will not take the day. If anybody, fuck off. Anybody my age would have laughed the fuck out of that. If Colin Quinn was here, he would have fucking been on the ground dying. All right? I can't help it that you cunts don't know who Pia Zadora is.
He might be doing that wherever he is right now. Okay, I have it already.
That just was sad. That was too
hope not.
That was fucking me.
What did Bobby have for you? Was it a
He had a crush
thing?
On me. He had a sexual crush on me.
Nice. Yeah. That went away.
Is it the hair? Was it the hair?
It was the hair. Not this fucking Larry from Three Stooges shit. but yeah, back then, he was a little fucking twink.
Yeah, in my early to mid-20s, Bobby... Well, he wanted to be intimate with me physically.
No,
me.
I wanted to force myself on. Yeah. There was a video of him. He tied his shirt into a knot and sang me "Happy Birthday" like Marilyn Monroe.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, and then sat on my lap.
I sat on yeah, and then remember that
did he get hard?
At one point, I sat on his lap at his request with my shirt off, and he applied lotion to my back. Because Bob was just like, that'd be funny, dude. It was for
Jesus
funny.
Jesus Christ.
Just as a joke. And I was like, okay, I'll do it as a joke. Like, if it's just funny.
As a goof.
That was Bobby's gay phase.
Yeah, I was young and naive.
What do you mean was?
Yeah, phase. Phase implies it stopped.
Yeah. I think the show was mostly guys.
Yeah.
I like looking at you hot twinks. So they take your dick out. Take your dick
I'm
out.
I'm a cub.
You're a cub.
We've discussed this.
What are you? He's a bear.
I guess I'm a bear.
What? He's a twink.
I'm abused.
What would you be? Just a...
Yeah, bear. I'm just...
He's a predator.
No, I'm not that hairy, though.
Yeah, I'm not a hairy man.
He's a last resort.
I'm a sloppy party bottom.
Fuck pig, I believe is the term.
A fuck pig. Shit. Unbelievable. What's good chat saying, buddy? What do we got in there?
Someone says that Sammy and his wife are the new Lewis and B because of all the fighting.
Who's Lewis and B?
You cheat on your wife all the time? Fuck him, he's in Mexico.
I want Zach.
Oh,
I think I want Zach.
Oh, he's going to text me in 5 seconds.
I want Zach. I want fucking Zac. Jesus
fucking
Christ.
Ruthless. Holy shit.
My God. Zac, what the fuck? Is he in Mexico?
That text is coming, yeah. Yeah, he's on his way to Mexico.
Dude, don't fucking turn on me. You're a go-mite.
I fucking made you.
I made you. You're a go-mite.
You just unmade him, apparently. I'll take that.
Right. Oof.
Well, unmade his marriage? I don't know.
Nope.
Mm-hmm. Nope. That wasn't the issue.
Now, did you just try to resell it?
Well, fix it.
Cocksucker fucking re-gifted a shitty joke.
Indian gave it.
What are you... Oh, wow. Oh, fuck it.
Jeez, on a roll.
We should give you that blanket they're sitting on. Hey, what do you got?
George Coleman says, Sam should be out foraging for berries and clubbing women.
I'm a caveman. Oh, because I look like a caveman.
Like the Geico caveman.
Yeah.
That's a. My forehead protrudes slightly, and I have a
what do you
very
got,
pronounced
what
brow.
What else you got? You got anything in Bobby it's chat good, that's good?
The latest comment is, did they comment on Cake Stomp?
What's Cake Stomp?
It's Opie's video that Reddit is obsessed with again.
Yeah.
Oh, Reddit.
You remember? You remember
8 years ago, right?
It was a long time ago. It was when we were doing the walkover from K-Rock to XM.
How many years is that?
Yeah, probably like 8 years. And so, yeah, Opie stomped a homeless man's cake and then gave him money, you know.
How much
and
money?
I don't know, a whole bunch of it. He just threw a bunch of cash. I don't know how much it was.
More than the cake was worth.
Yeah, definitely. So, enough to buy a new cake.
What if the cake was made by a famous baker?
It was pretty good.
Like who?
I don't know.
Like the cake boss.
Baker Le Javon. Yeah.
Cake boss.
Cake boss. Yeah, cake
fondant
boss.
Firefighters on it and stuff. Yeah, so
that'd be funny if the cake was a September 11th.
Yeah,
that's what it was. The towers. Oh, if someone picked that up and they're just stepping on the towers.
He kicked over the one tower and then 9 minutes later.
they put that music.
But every like
Chris Italia saving people around the cake.
Every year or two, people get obsessed with the video again, and so it ends up on Reddit, and people go, like, this is terrible. And the problem is the title of it.
Yeah.
What's the title of
it? It's like it goes...
White man with millions?
This is what it is every time. Millionaire shock jock is what he's described as. Yeah. And there is no sympathy that anyone can have for a man named Millionaire Shock Jock.
Wow.
So, and then they go, oh, look at what he did to this homeless guy, and then everybody goes, he's a terrible person. And then Opie goes, well, we gave him a bunch of money, and then it dies down. Generally, that's the cycle.
Right.
You know, so we're in the middle of that cycle right now where Opie's going, we gave him a bunch of money. And then we're probably like, tomorrow's Friday, so by Monday, we'll be in the die down phase, I think.
This comes out Monday, though, so what if this reignites it? What if this is the fucking thing that just lights the spark again on Monday? And then what if Ellen listened to the show secretly? And then on Monday, she has that clip.
There's a 0% chance of that happening, I think.
But right? what if she actually finds that guy and then brings him in on the show, shows the clip, everybody cries, and then she gives him a cake from the cake boss and a car and a career, right?
Yeah, and then he wastes it all like the homeless voiceover guy.
Yeah, that was awesome.
What did he do?
He just fucking went back to
He's gone,
stuff.
Yeah.
I haven't heard of
him. He was homeless in 3 weeks again. No
shit. Yeah,
seriously. He had a job, too, right?
Are you talking about Jad Fan from Last Comedy? What the fuck, really?
Ted Williams, he got a job with Kraft.
He
was doing the macaroni
the
and cheese voice.
Too. The Cleveland Cavaliers were going to make
and
him
then
an announcer.
He spent all the money on buying his daughters that he never paid attention to, like Prada bags and stuff. Aww. I bought you a Louis Vuitton. And then everybody realized.
He got to a fight at a hotel because he was drunk.
Yeah, he realized he was a degenerate. So I think like a year later they did a follow-up. And I think he was sleeping in a car and doing a weekly radio show at like a local tiny affiliate place.
So he's just a regular radio guy now.
Exactly.
So he's a pretty successful radio guy.
It's still better than being homeless. He's got
Isn't
a car.
It's fucking sad what happened to radio.
Oh, it's terrible.
Radio guys were, rock stars.
Yeah.
Rock stars in the fucking 80s, 90s.
Yeah.
And now it's just fuck, man. They don't. What?
You're saying that from the technology that makes them not have a job anymore? Podcasts.
Yeah, I don't think this is.
I don't think so either.
I really don't think
podcasting came from the inability of
to make
people
money.
To do well on radio.
I think this is the actual savior of that.
Yeah.
They can go if they want and if they are good. I mean, Stern says it. Opposite Howard Stern's like podcasting's horseshit. You'll never if you want to be a real broadcaster, go into radio. I mean, I get what he's saying.
It's incorrect.
That's just kind of being out of touch, I think.
Well, what he's saying is, look, you want to be a radio guy, go do radio in shit places, make no money for years.
But that's not the way the business
works.
That's
an outdated model, yeah.
But build up a fucking, do something original where people will start listening.
You can't.
Cowhead does it.
Yeah, but Cowhead was doing it in the 90s. I mean, Cowhead's been doing it forever.
Yeah, I don't think that model exists really anymore. I feel like you have to do a podcast, right?
I don't know.
Well, and that's the other thing. There's like, are young people listening to radio as much? Or you can go on YouTube and become a celebrity. You can do a podcast. There's so many different avenues for you to gain exposure. The idea that you're going to gain exposure on like a local FM affiliate,
right?
It doesn't happen anymore.
Yeah,
I mean, all these local affiliates anyway, they either pay no money and you're not allowed to do anything. What are you going to send your tapes around? Like any big radio station, they've got their hands all over these jocks so much that they can't do anything anyway. Or
you can go to
they're hiring one person to do voice tracks for New York, Detroit, Cleveland, and it's just one guy who's doing all these jobs for $30,000.
Or you can just listen to podcasts and there's no rules. You can say whatever you want.
How does a podcasting work?
When you're on radio,
what does your boss think of the podcast that we're doing here? Like, does your boss ever?
I got no rules.
What?
Dude, no rules.
Whoa. What is this? The Wild West? Is this some kind of new frontier? So what do you? I mean, doesn't the FCC get mad when you put this on the radio?
Dude, there's no rules.
So where can be?
certainly, there's some rules.
I don't understand. Where can people hear the show we're on right now?
Guys.
On the radio.
Guys.
Is it a TV?
It's no rules.
So then where do...
On the internet.
The...
Whoa.
What?
World Wide Web. You know what's on that? No rules.
No, I thought this was just a the government
only rule
thing. The internet?
Is that there are no rules.
There's no fucking rules, Zach. Like that shirt. No rules. There's no fucking rules.
So you mean to tell me...
I'm on the internet where there's the Wild West.
Wow.
No rules.
Okay. And there aren't any rules.
I know. Come into the saloon with your guns and shoot the ceilings.
And nobody's going to stop you.
There's no rule. Pow, 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 pow. Take a sip. Barkeep. Keep them cut. Pow, pow, pow.
Well, don't you have to pay for the drink?
Hey. No rules.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It's that simple.
Great.
Wow. So that's really what people should be
looking
into.
Someone's
going to
take that screenshot and fucking put some terrorism behind it. This is what we should be doing.
Yeah.
So what are you saying, Scopo?
No, I'm good. I'm good right now.
Where's my water?
Just saying, as a fan, I don't listen to the radio
What's
anymore.
What's your name again?
Chris.
Okay.
I don't listen to the radio at all.
Really?
Too many rules just is a problem.
There's too many rules.
Just all pot. Yeah, too many yeah. rules. Absolutely.
And you live in, you're a crime analysis judger, so you are living a life full of rules.
One of those crime judgers.
So. But yeah, no.
One of those well-known crime judgers.
But
4-year degree for that job.
What's your favorite show? What's your favorite shows? I won't put you on the spot. What's your favorite shows?
This is the first one I listen to. It's almost like a ritual every week. I listen to this, then Burr, and then that'll usually get me to Tuesday, and then it's Tuesdays with Stories.
Right.
And then, you know, Legion of Skanks, now that, you know, that took me over to the Kumia network, but terrestrial radio is not a good thing anymore.
The one point that Howard made that is 100% true is all those shows that he just mentioned, those people have built audiences outside of podcasting. That's the one thing that isn't happening for the most part is people building audiences strictly on podcasting.
Well, can I say something?
There's so much of it.
I built a lot of guys from – I got a lot of people from O&A on my show from doing that.
Mm-hmm.
But I built – I've actually got my own fans. Because the one thing from my show, I knew I had to go and get my own fans. I had to go do something that was mine because I had to build something so that people get me. Because I do O&A, that's a little part of me. That was a small
little
part of me.
You're also a comic.
I'm a comic, but a lot of guys would go to my shows from O&A and go, dude, you're real funny. Because you're on O&A, you're kind of that guy.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then they go, I'm not that guy who fucking... You know, whatever we do on that show, I'm a fucking stand-up comic number one. That's what I fucking do. Maybe an actor number two, you know, but that's my comedy. That's what I do. So you come see me. The reason why I'm doing this show, Opie and Anthony show, was to get you to come to this show. But I needed to find a way to get my fans. I needed them to be mine.
Totally.
I needed them to be like, I know what you do. I know your stand-up. I know your podcast. I know the people you hang out with. But I know what type of guy you are. Totally. So that's what podcasting does.
But I think what you're saying is that it all kind of folds into each other, right? That you have to... Because as a touring comic, that's a built-in way that you're going to build an audience.
I mean, you're not going to build an audience going to local FM radio markets, but there you do still have to build an audience, whether you're a comedian, whether you're doing shit on YouTube. You have to do something to stand out that will draw people to a podcast, at least to start with. And then eventually your podcast can spread via word of mouth.
Some of them don't, man. So, you know, some of them, you know, my podcast is evolved. I always let it evolve into what I think where it's going. I never made it one thing and just kept it that way.
Right.
Because I would just keep those fans and that's it. And there's a fucking ceiling to that.
Totally.
You know, I mean, now, I mean, look, I got three fucking hot broads from Buffalo.
One of them's a little curvy.
What? They're, well,
voluptuous.
Voluptuous.
They're all fucking like, fuck off.
Okay, no, just because what sexy. You said before.
Yeah.
No, you said that.
I asked it. I didn't say, because I wasn't even there, so
like
I don't
pizza.
Know. I've never seen her.
They
love pizza and difficult to lift.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
This is from your story, because I've never seen them.
That's a good Buffalo 10. Yeah.
I don't know what they look like.
What did you say, a Buffalo 10?
Buffalo 10, man.
What do you have against Buffalo?
Dude, Buffalo, they got some nice... beautiful bovine women.
Let me tell you something. The fucking chicks in Buffalo, I wish I wasn't married because I do a lot of shows in Buffalo because they like to get down. You go up there and they're like, yeah, let's fucking go. I've had some serious sex in Buffalo. Mm. Like serious sex in Buffalo because it's Buffalo. It's like you come up. Even if you're from New York, that's almost like being famous. Like, you live in the city? Like, you know what I mean? It's like
Buffalo, Alabama? Is that what
Yeah, but you gotta be careful because you'll find them in your luggage. Take me with you. I love
Buffalo. I got laid at a Buffalo bar show and I fucking stink.
Yeah. I mean, really smell.
Yeah, no, he really smells.
Like, you don't shower.
Yeah.
Do you smell?
Sometimes. Well, I used to more.
Why did you? What did you get a pep talk from Lewis? Dude, you gotta shower.
No, I came from a very Gigi Allen state of mind. I was like a weird punk kid for a long time.
Really?
Now I'm finally entering society.
So you smelled just like, fuck it, you don't need to shower. This is what I am.
Yeah, I was an animal.
So really?
That's such a thing. All these punk kids, cross punks, and even just like, just in general, so many musicians in Baltimore just smelled horrific. The best, like, and they fucked all the time. I don't know how it was possible that it was like you're emitting an odor that should just repulse people, but...
Oh, when you sleep floor to floor. I mean, I was on tour with my band for a long time, and, you know, you slept in the car, or you slept on the band you opened for's floor, and so, yeah, sometimes you're a gross person. But
what do you play?
I play keyboards.
No shit. You play guitar at all?
No, I just play synthesizers.
Oh, okay, cool. Maybe we'll jam sometime.
Yeah, I'd love that, man.
All right, cool. What are you laughing at?
Just a keyboard and guitar are two totally different instruments. Why would you think that he played guitar after he said he played keyboard?
Flock of Seagulls?
That's a keytar. That's different.
Well, fucking jam, dude. And I ran.
Oh, that's my shit.
And so doom da boom da bow doom bow dooka dooka bow.
This is great.
Alright, we're going to wrap this fucker up. This has been a great show. You guys are great for coming in. Thank you so much. Let's go through the room real quick. We're going to go for you first. What do you got, Stav?
One sec. So follow me on Twitter, @StavComedy. And I also have an erotic Instagram account that I'm really trying to get off the floor.
Can I just stop for one second? It's the funniest thing in the world. It's disgusting, and you're going to go... You don't want to look at it, like, in public if you're at work. Please don't bring this up on your computer. You will be fired.
Please do.
Okay, he has a thing on it.
It's on Instagram.
What's
it's
it called?
@Stavy Baby, StavyBaby, Baby.
What's the thing I like that you say, what's the workout one I love?
There's one workout video, Hawaiian Fitness.
Yes.
Please check it out. Really good stuff.
What's the push-up one thing?
That's the Hawaiian Fitness. And oh, the Lover's Push-Up.
It's called the Lover's Push-Up?
Yeah.
It's the funniest thing I've ever fucking
seen.
Thank
you.
It's Stavros. On the ground.
Don't ruin it. Come on.
And I fuck off.
All right, go ahead.
I'm not
going
to ruin it. I'm going to get it to go. All right, fuck you. You want me to spoil it?
Spoil it.
You're not a fucking Transformer movie.
Right. It's a 6-second video.
Yeah, it's a 6-second. Dude, Stavros is on the ground, and another guy's on top of him, and they're hand to hand on top of each other. And the guy pushes off when he comes back down. They kiss. The fucking greatest.
Yeah, please check that out.
Yep. What else you got? You're with me.
I'm with you at Ridgefield, right? Ridgefield
Playhouse coming up.
And maybe some other stuff.
And Paul Verzi's with us, too.
Oh, that's going to be a fun one.
So if you're in Connecticut, get the fuck on it. Get your tickets. Stop fucking around.
And then the first weekend in November, I'm at the DC Improv. So come. I'm opening for Dave Attell. It should be awesome.
That's awesome, man. Yeah. Great. All right, we'll try to get you in this club, too. You ready to get in the cellar? Not yet.
Yeah, you know.
Not yet. You want to?
You really impressed Estee before, so.
All right, Deepu over there. Another
Armor Deep.
Armor Deep. Yeah, we'll talk about it.
Okay. What do you got?
I'm at Radio.
Sam.
Thank you.
I was going to plug him.
No, I'm kidding. What do you got, Adrian?
I'm at Radio Adrian 1 on Twitter and Instagram, and Sam Roberts Show, Monday through Friday, 9 to midnight on OB Radio. Great. Serious.
He plugged himself first.
Well, yeah.
Hey, it's your guy. He's not my guy anymore.
You taught me.
He's your guy.
No, I didn't teach
you. Watch what my guy does.
By the way, you can go to notsam.com for everything, and my show...
YouTube.com/notsam.
Don't interrupt my plug.
Sorry.
...is Sam Roberts Show nights on OB Radio. Also, the wrestling podcast, if you're wrestling fans, download Sam Roberts Wrestling Podcast. But it's all at notsam.com.
Awesome.
Thanks, man.
Where is the Sam? Where is that podcast? Just anywhere?
Yeah, it's on iTunes. It's on notsam.com.
You have
it's
a
on
network
Stitcher.
You're on?
No, man. No.
All right. What do you got?
It's very, very successful, though.
All right. We should talk.
Very successful.
I know. What do you got?
Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Zac is not funny. Zac is not funny.
That's ironic.
Thank you. You got it. On October 24th, I'll probably get kicked off the show I'm supposed to do with Louis J. Gomez.
Why?
Because I blew up his spot.
Well,
remember
won't
before
do that.
When he said Louis cheats on his wife?
Thanks, Sam.
bring it back up.
Thanks. October 24th, I'll be at Poughkeepsie with Louis and Chris Scopo. And look out for my new movie, Return to Nukem High, Volume 2, starring me, Bailey J, Lemmy from Motorhead, and Ron Jeremy. We have a test screening October the 10th at Videology in Brooklyn.
Well, are you friends with Bailey J?
Awesome. Yeah, she's in my movie.
How'd you fucking meet Bailey J?
I heard her on this show in contact.
Exactly. Everything stems from this show. Tuesdays with Stories.
Sam
Bailey J.
Legions of fucking everything.
Sam came to see the premiere of Volume 1 of the movie and has the poster
because
framed on his wall.
Why? Right. Because of this show.
No,
because
I've been a Troma fan for a long time.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah, no, it had nothing to do with it.
But yeah, Bailey J, I totally heard on the show and
I
stole
her
for my movie.
I fucking love her. God, do I love her. Anyways, what else?
That's good.
All right, Scopo, what do I got?
You got coming up. You're August 2nd, you're going to be at the Hoboken Comedy Festival.
Could you have any enthusiasm whatsoever? Like, you see how he did his plugs?
Do you know why? Because I couldn't find the date, so I was looking, I scrolled back too far.
That's
and
awful.
Then Fort Lauderdale, he's coming.
Don't
October
scream.
8th, 9th,
enthusiasm
10th.
Enthusiasm is not screaming.
In the Improv at Fort Lauderdale. Albany, October 15th, Comedy Works, 15th, 16th, 17th. And then you're going to be at the Ridgefield Playhouse, the 23rd. Then you're going for like 2 weeks, November 5th
Big
through
tour
the
Big tour.
Wow, 5th through the 20th, you're at the JFL Anniversary Tour.
Yes, I am. I'm very excited about that. Very excited about that. Big tour, 15 days in Canada, huge shows, Massey Hall. Oh, dude, just huge theaters. I'm a little nervous.
Don't be nervous. You're going to do great. No,
well, you got to do clean. You know what I mean? It can't be too edgy.
Yeah, that's not great for you then.
Well, no, I can do it. Believe
yeah, you can do it, but is it the best? You know, I don't know. We'll see, though.
I like these things that are growing off your skull. you look like a Star Trek, like a human, but not a human. You know, those planets.
Vulcan.
That,
I'm kind of into it.
A little longer.
Thank
you.
You
like
much.
It?
Yeah, it's cool.
She does like
you know
it.
What, Lauren? You've never
like
said
Lauren.
Anything about me that
oh,
you're into.
I love you.
Yeah, no,
thank
that's
you.
Uncle love.
I'm into your lips.
Oh.
Who's not into
who isn't? Jesus Christ, my mom wants to kiss me extra. All right, well, what else do I got? Anything else?
That was it. And if you want to send stuff for the studio, send it to 117 McDougal Street.
What's the zip code?
10012.
Got it.
In care of YKWD, please.
Yes.
And it will get to us. We'll put it up behind you, like the Bill Murray photo, framed photo from our friend
Chris.
I got it.
Thanks, Bob.
Chris. I really do. That was great that you put that in. That you gave it to us. We love that. What else? And if you want to come in, go ahead. Come on. Let's go.
Hey, if you want to come in, email YKWDproducer at riotcast.com and just send me an email. That's it.
Yeah, Matt from Laugh Button says he hates the only part of the show he hates is when I yell at you.
Really? Aww,
yeah.
That's strange.
Yeah, it is. Shut the fuck up.
It's my favorite part of the show.
It's really, just shut up when I'm talking to you, okay?
Okay.
I told him I forgot to do it today. I told him I'm going to do it every show now, just to piss him off. So I love that. Hopefully he made it through the whole episode, and I just made him angry. But I like the show, but shut the fuck up. I love Matt. I love those guys from Laugh Button. What do you got, sweetie?
At Lauren Kubera on Twitter, and I'll be here chilling.
Awesome. Great.
Hanging out.
Guys, I want to thank you for coming in. You want to plug your thing, or are you good?
No, Bobby, I just want to say thank you.
Buddy, you have fun? Yeah,
absolutely.
Awesome.
I'd like to say thank you, too.
Dude,
I don't have anything to plug.
You have nothing to plug at all?
No, sorry.
Well, you guys are fucking great, guys. You had a fun time? It was cool, right?
Yeah, thank you.
Guys, anytime you want to come back, just not next week or the week after or the week after that, or actually 3 weeks, I got to go in Canada. So around a month, 2-4 months from now, if you want to come back. No, I'm serious. You guys are great. Thanks for coming in. We're going to be doing these live now. We're going to fill up. We got around four more seats we can do. We'd like some chicks. Actually, those girls from Buffalo are going to come down to the live show. We're going to hook that up.
We got a chick coming in next week.
We have a girl coming in.
Just one girl.
All right. Well, let's get another person in so she's not uncomfortable. Because you know it's just going to be all about her. Right?
Okay. Are your boobs
real? Is your ass fake?
What's that?
No, we're going to ask her, are her tits real? Whatever.
She's very excited to come. She can't wait.
Oh, okay. No, finish, Deepu, please. Let's end the show on a high note.
I can't sustain that. I fucked up.
Deepu,
Bobby just shamed him.
All right, man. You guys are the best fans in the fucking world. Thanks for listening live, for being in the chat room, participating. I want to thank Estee and Noam for stopping by. That was pretty epic. And you guys, make sure you spread the word. Subscribe to this channel. If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe. Don't be a dickhead. Subscribe, review, and spread the word of the You Know What Dude podcast. You know what, dude? We'll see you next week.
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs.
Shitty jobs. Shitty jobs.
Check out riotcast.com for all of the best podcasts on the internet. And they are all free.
And they are all free.